Hear a knock on the door and the night begins. Cause we've done this before, so you come on in. Make yourself at my home, tell me where you been. Pour yourself something cold, baby, cheers to this. Sometimes you gotta stay in, and you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay in, and welcome to my house. Baby, take control now. We can't even slow down. We don't have to go out. Welcome to my house.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome into the Cabinets Feed and Seed pregame show. I'm Tommy Wood along with David Burkhalter. We're back at Volunteer Stadium where tonight the Vols take on the Sylacauga Aggies in a huge Class 5A Region 3 showdown. And, you know, David, both of these teams come in 3-1. We're winding down the stretch of the region season, and this is a very important game for both of these teams.
You're definitely right, Tommy. I mean, both teams have already nailed down a playoff spot, so we know that we'll be in the second part of the season later on in the year. But this is for control of that second seed placement where you get home field advantage in the first round of the playoffs. And we're going to need it with the region that we're matched up with. Home field advantage means a lot. So this is a must win for both teams, really, in order to get that second seed.
To kind of let you know how the playoffs are shaking up, a win tonight could do a lot to hosting again, as David
right.
said, the first round. That would mean more than likely Vigor coming into town. But a loss could send you back to St. Paul's, and that's a tough row to hoe right there when you talk about St. Paul's.
Well, obviously, St. Paul's is one of the best teams in the state. That's a long trip to make. And, you know, that says it really – it's hard to make a trip like that and be mentally and physically prepared to play when you get there. So it means a lot to this team to be able to host a first-round playoff game here. I mean, obviously, you'll have a bigger fan base. You'll have more support at home. So it's an important thing tonight. We got to come out with a win.
Last Friday night, the Vols fall 28-7 on the road at Beauregard. And, you know, offensively, David, we never really got started. I think I had about 127 yards or so of offense. And what are some of the things that really – came into play in that game?
Well, obviously, I mean, you have to give credit to Beauregard's defense. They have a really good defense. That nose guard number 90, his name slips my mind right now. Obviously, he's going to be playing at the next level. He's got the size and the talent. But they did a good job of dialing up pressure, and we didn't do a very good job of picking up some of the stunts and blitzes. Now, like I said, give credit to Beauregard. They had a great defense, but we've got to do a better job of getting our head up before the snap, picking up those blitzes, and adjusting at the line of scrimmage. So you got to expect that Sylacauga is going to have seen that tape and prepared for some of that tonight. They're going to have some blitzes. They're going to have some stunts. And we just got to be able to pick it up.
And I think that last week Beauregard seemed to be on the attack a whole
right,
lot more
yeah.
than we did offensively.
Sure.
That's going to have to change tonight. Sylacauga gave up 48 points last week, but they put up 49. They get a big win over Shelby County by one. And I tell you, going back and watching some of the film, yeah, they gave up some big plays, but that offense from Sylacauga, they can put some points up.
Oh, yeah, man, that offense from Sylacauga, it's all facilitated by their really good running back. I mean, we were talking about it before the break here. He's just really good. I mean, it seems like every week we play a team that has a great
right.
running back. Well, that streak continues tonight. We've got to be able to hem him up. They like to start off in the eye and sort of transition to the spread as the game goes along. They're about 50-50 run throw. So, you know, it's just we got to play good technique. We've got to be sound tacklers like every week, and I think we'll be okay.
That's the way it's going to go tonight. Again, Cabinets Feed and Seed pregame show. We're going to continue in just a moment. Again, Sylacauga and Central Clay taking part in this battle tonight here at Volunteer Stadium. We'll be back with more on WAXC-TV.
You may know them from high school, from the local grocery store, or even your own neighborhood. These local teens have embarked on a new journey, one that begins at Southern Union State Community College. Visit suscc.edu/journey to see the life's journey these students have planned. We believe that you have an amazing journey ahead of you too. And Southern Union is the perfect place to begin at an affordable price close to home. Southern Union, where the journey begins.
Young's Drugstore has proudly served the citizens of Lineville and the surrounding areas for more than 50 years, providing fast, friendly service. At Young's Drugstore, you're more than just a number, which is why we strive to always greet you with a warm hello and friendly smile. Young's Drugstore offers a convenient drive-through window, prescription compounding, vaccination services, and after-hours emergency availability to better serve you. Young's Drugstore now even has the convenience of viewing and refilling your prescriptions online at youngsdrugstorellc.com. Young's Drugstore, located on Highway 9 in Lineville, 256-396-5632.
First State Bank is a community-owned bank established in 1971 with a mission to be the bank for all people in the area with a primary focus on good old-fashioned customer service. First State Bank has convenient branches located in Lineville, Ashland, and Wedowee. Since its founding, First State Bank has continued to grow and keep up with the banking industry changes in technology to give its customers the best service available, such as internet and mobile banking. First State Bank, here to make dreams come true for people just like you.
At Cabinets Direct, we strive to provide top-quality products along with professional and courteous service. As a family-owned and operated company, we have over 40 years of combined experience in cabinetry sales and installation. We offer a wide range of cabinetry with fully customizable options. We also use only locally made products, keeping our money in our community. For more information, give us a call or visit our showroom. Cabinets Direct.
For over 35 years, Dairy Delight in Ashland has been providing the area some of the best of your favorite comfort food. From the best burgers around to their famous hot dogs and chicken fingers and sandwiches, even the pickiest of eaters can find some great food at Dairy Delight. And never leave without getting one of the hand-spun milkshakes, banana splits, or soft-serve ice cream just to top it off. Visit Dairy Delight on Highway 77 North, just off the square in downtown Ashland, to discover what everyone's talking about and become a customer for life.
Are you sure we should take this billboard down?
People find out State Farm does car loans as well as they do insurance. Our bank is through.
Good point. Grab an edge.
Look, there's two guys on the State Farm Borrow Better Banking sign.
No, for real, there's two dudes on the State Farm
Borrow Better Banking sign.
Gentlemen, please get down from the State Farm Borrow Better Banking sign. Phil, get the hose.
Okay, he's getting the hose.
All right, let's go.
Want to borrow better? Contact State Farm agent Mike Coleman about a car loan that can save you hundreds.
The best Mexican dining experience around is found at Monte Alban Mexican Restaurant. Real authentic Mexican cuisine and atmosphere awaits you at Monte Alban, with great specials on popular dishes such as the pollo asado and beef or chicken chimichangas. Choose from select dinner or lunch combinations, and you can buy one and get one half off. Want to celebrate your birthday? Get a free drink, meal, and dessert when you dine in. Two convenient locations on the Court Square in Ashland and on Highway 9 in Lineville to serve you.
And welcome back once again, Cabinets Feed and Seed pregame show. Tommy Wood, David Burkhalter here at Volunteer Stadium. Tonight it's week number 8 of the high school football season. Believe it or not, 80% of the season about done here. But the Vols taking on the Sylacauga Aggies here in week number 8. And both teams come in 3-1 in region play. And we talked about the Vols last week falling 28-7 offensively. What are some things that you see, again, that have to take place for this Vol team really to get things going tonight?
Well, I think the key to tonight, Tommy, one of the big keys for tonight, I should say, is starting early and hitting quick. We got to get things going at the beginning of the game. 2 weeks ago, we scored 68 points. We can't be stopped. Marbury, all night long, we were doing whatever we wanted to and running the ball at will, throwing the ball really well, hitting our targets on time. Then last week, we did a really poor job, I felt like, of getting a good momentum going offensively. We didn't get in rhythm, and when we had something going, well, we'd shoot ourselves in the foot, maybe get a penalty or a big play where they'd sack us for a loss. We can't have that tonight. We've got to hit early. We've got to hit often. We've got to get in that flow and that momentum and keep that going all night.
Defensively, it's going to be huge tonight for this Vol defense to read keys.
Right.
They love to run the zone read. You're going to see a lot of that tonight. Also an outstanding quarterback that can step back, throw a pass downfield. Yeah. That's going to be a big key as well. So reading the keys, don't get lost in the window dressing. That's going to be a big key for this Vol defense.
Well, look, Sylacauga is an option football team. They like to run the zone read, like you said. They'll also run some versions of the triple option. But off of that, what I'm really most concerned about, and it goes back to reading those keys, is they like to do a little play action off that zone read and try to burn you deep downfield. We can't let that happen. our linebackers and our safeties have to read their keys and know that they can't let somebody behind them or in that curl zone in the middle of the field and let them pick up that first down. Their quarterback is very accurate. He doesn't have the strongest arm, but he's extremely accurate. And if you let him, he can burn you deep.
That's it for the Cabinets Feed and Seed pregame show. We'll come back with kickoff in just a moment.
For over 30 years, Tallapoosa Ford has been your family-owned auto dealer for hot trucks and SUVs. Now they're raising the bar even higher. The Ford F-150 has been the best-selling truck in America for the last 38 years. And the hot new 15s are hitting the scene. And Tallapoosa Ford and Ford trucks are number one for a reason. America's best truck, combined with our award-winning service department for the region's best warranty work and great maintenance and service.
Hello, this is Jeff with Tallapoosa Ford. Ford trucks have led America's truck sales. Come by today and get your best deal on America's best truck. We don't want all the business, just the opportunity to earn yours.
In a world that's ever-changing, you have to be sure that your choices are the right choices. At Central Alabama Community College, you'll know you made the best choice. We understand that you need the best educational opportunities. Whether choosing a technical degree program, taking courses to transfer to a four-year college or university, or being a part of our national championship-winning traditions, Central Alabama will provide you with courses and degree programs in tune with today's workplace. Get a sharper focus on your life by choosing one of our three convenient locations, Alex City, Childersburg, and Talladega. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
Cabinets Feed and Farm Supply on the corner of Highway 280 and Quarry Road in Sylacauga is Central Alabama's complete feed and farm supply headquarters with full feed lines for horses, cattle, and pets from Purina, Nutrina, and Pennington. And if you're gearing up for hunting season, make sure to get all your clover and deer mixes. Need more space or own your own hunting club? Find full lines of Cotton State buildings at Cabinets and free delivery for 50 miles and relaxed financing. Get all your land, farm, and feed needs from Cabinets Feed and Farm on Highway 280 in Sylacauga.
There's people who care where I'm going, and good friends who welcome me home. So get a full tank of freedom, drive the American road. And with a full tank of freedom, find your own highway. We'll take you wherever you go. Take you wherever you go.
Visit any of these area Marathon Station locations.
Lineville Health and Rehab in Lineville, Alabama has a staff and has had a staff of caring folks for years. If it has come that time in life for that person in your family to look at the possibility of going into a health and rehab facility, you have a choice. You have a choice to choose, and the fine folks at Lineville Health and Rehab would like to take this time to invite you by to meet them and them you. Caring folks that care for you and your family. You have a choice. The number to call is 256-396-2104.
No matter where your day takes you, a water heater from Blossman means a reliable hot shower when you need it.
Here's the deal. Standard tank propane water heaters for only $99. Free installation.
Red's Catfish Cabin in Crackford, Alabama is adding tailgate specials just for you. Hot wings, bio wings. You can buy one or 200. Get with Larry and the crew at 256-354-7705. Now, they still going to have that delicious catfish that they're known for, sweet tea, which they're known for, and everything else. If you've never eaten at Red's Catfish Cabin, I want you to go today. That's in Crackford, Alabama.
Welcome back to Volunteer Stadium. We see the captains meeting out at midfield, getting ready for the Lionville Health and Rehab coin toss. Of course, Lionville Health and Rehab, our family caring for yours. Taking a look at your captains for the Central Vols. They are Blair Lacey, as well as Jeremy Thompson and Malik Dark. And they are meeting on the other side from Sylacauga, Alex Thomason, and also number 87, Mason Owen. And you talk about Alex Thomason, David. You're talking about a running back that talking to a good friend of mine from Sylacauga. His freshman year, he said he was as skinny as a goalpost, and now he has developed into a good-looking running back and really a more physical back as well.
Yeah, he has, Tommy, and you can see that in his play. He's not scared to give you head and shoulders and run somebody over, but at the same time, he's got the ability to put a move on you. So that's somebody, and it's like we said earlier, it seems like week after week after week we've played a team that has a really good running back. Well, that's going to continue tonight. He's somebody that will have to tackle low, get those legs out from under him, and gang tackle. So, you know, we got to do what we got to do and tackle as a team, and we'll be fine. But he is a very good, very good-looking athlete.
Beautiful night here. The first, really the feel of fall.
Yeah.
We break out the long sleeves, and it is, again, a cool night, especially after the sun went down. Going to cool off throughout the evening. Sylacauga will take the opening kick as they will start on offense first. Let's talk about this Sylacauga Aggie offense. Jackson Walker, the junior quarterback, 6 foot, 170. As we mentioned, Thomason now 5'10", 190. He is a junior in the backfield. On the outside as well, Kevion Ross, 5'7", 150, a junior. Mason Owen, we just mentioned, as a captain, 6'2", 220. He is a wideout, a senior as well. And we say wideout, he's actually an extended tight end. In this formation, a lot of times you'll see as a tight end, he'll slide out about 3 or 4 yards as he will line up and pretty much an excellent blocker on the corner there. The Dontario Story is a wideout, 5'7", 155. He is a senior, 5'7", 155. And Aaron Bryant, he is a sophomore wideout, 5'10", 140. Suffering an injury this week and having to do it without number two, Bailey Ward. He is a 6'1", 155-pound sophomore. Injured last Friday. He will sit out tonight for Sylacauga. But this guy can make some things happen. They will miss him offensively. On the front line, you got Chase Pruitt. He is a 5'9", 235-pound junior at center. The guards are Coy Whitehead, 5'9", 215, as junior. Austin Decker, 5'10", 240, a junior. And the tackles, Devin Smith, 6'2", 300, a senior, and Daniel Roberts, 5'11", 215. He is a senior. The Central Vol defense, David, you talk about Malik Dark up front. He has really been a pass rusher throughout the season and gets a great push up front.
Yeah, that's right, Tommy. He's been our biggest benefit there as far as pass rushing at the nose guard position. He's not real big, but he's really quick and he's really strong, so he does a good job there. Our tackles have done really well in the last couple of weeks as well. Casey Jones, Dawson Taylor, both around 6'2", weighing a little over 200 pounds. Our outside linebackers play great technique. Jacob Lett, Marcus Heflin, our inside linebackers. Those are the key to tonight's game. Got to play good technique. Clay Tuck, Tyler Smith, and then our secondary. Everybody knows what they can do. Great athletes in Davin, Ladarius DJ, and John David Morgan.
Klein McKinney to kick it off for your Southern Union kickoff. Begin there. Go anywhere. We're going to begin this game with a Vol kickoff. Thomason back deep for Sylacauga, as it will be taken by one of the up men at the 20-yard line, 25, a little gap up the middle across the 30, and bringing it out to about the 34 where he meets Popcorn, Zach Horn on the stop for the opening kick.
You know, I bet Zach Horn's had more tackles on kickoff than anybody else, any other two people put together this year. He does a great job of staying in his lane. He's supposed to be a wedge buster. He'll run straight through somebody and make a tackle. He's a great player, a great special teams player.
Sylacauga with the football to open it up. Looks like they'll go to the I formation to open up the ball game. Two split outs to the near side. I backfield. And movement. Get away with it. They'll reset the offense now. Power to the left side. Hand it off to the left side and hit in the backfield and driven back at about the 31-yard line. Tyler Smith gets the stop as Ross unable to get out of his tracks. It's a loss of a couple. Brings up second and 12.
Tyler Smith saw the guard pull from the backside and decided to take that gap. Shot the gap real hard. Now, that's a dangerous play. He could have been outran, but he did a good job of flowing down the line, making a good tackle. That's a great play there from the middle linebacker. Something that we've got to have tonight and able to be able to stop their run game.
Second down and 12, loading up the shotgun. Jackson Walker has Thomason to his left. Motion to the near side. They'll go to Thomason on the right. Tries to get to the corner. Clay Tuck's got him. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and Dawson Taylor also on the bottom of the pile. No gain on the play. Brings up third and long for the Aggies.
That's basically the same play, just a different formation. They pull that guard again, and Clay Tuck on this side this time shoots the gap again, flows down the line real well, same result. So two good plays from our middle linebackers to start the game. That's pretty good there for the Vols. I hope that can continue.
Third down at about 11. Jackson Walker, shotgun look. Receivers, two to his right, one to his left. We'll take the snap, roll to the left, or the right actually. Throw it down there too high, incomplete.
Good coverage that time from the Vols there. I thought that the 21 there was going to give up a little cushion and pick him up at the – but he picked him up at the sticks and prevented him from getting to the first down. And good coverage, and we'll get the ball back in fairly good field position, we should.
Punting the football for Sylacauga. It is Jacob Daniel. He'll punt it away. J.J. Jennings stands deep at his own 35-yard line. The Vols force an early three and out. Daniel kicks it out of there. Big boom and kick. Jennings goes back. He will field it back at the 20 and now retreat back to the 15. Looking for a block. Cuts it back. Breaks one tackle. Spins and will bring it out to about the 24-yard line. That's where the Vols will start. First down at 10.
Well, I mean, fairly good return from Jennings there, but I think – the best thing that happened to Jennings that time was that the punter just boomed that one and out-kicked his coverage. That was a college-level punt there. I mean, not only was it far, but it was extremely high as well. So a great punt there, and we're still in fairly good field position. It's like we said before the start of the game, Tommy, we got to get some momentum going here offensively early to start the game now.
We'll open up in the wishbone with two wide outs coming to the near side. Street drops it. It's on the turf. He'll recover it and lose back inside the 20 to the 19.
Well, just mishandled the snap there. I mean, you know, looked like the line had good, pretty good blocking. What it was a power play, and I thought it was going to be open. We just bobbled the snap, and that's just, you know, we talk about getting momentum early. That's not how you do it. That's something that we can't have tonight. I know we were fortunate to fall back on it, but we can't put the ball on the ground and give them an advantage.
Two wideouts go to the left. Shotgun look for Street. Second and long, Street steps back, got some pressure, throws it in the flats, catch is made, and back to the original line of scrimmage, but nothing more, brings up a third down and 10.
Well, look, I know we only picked up, what, 2 or 3 yards, maybe 4 that time, but that's our best offense. You know, we get it out to those good receivers. Those are our best athletes, Davin and DJ. Put the ball in their hands and let them try to do something with it. That time, good timing route ran, a good catch, and you know, we can live with 3 yards now. We got to make something happen here a little just because we put ourselves in a bind to start the game, but expect maybe a fake handoff with a long pass here or something like that.
Third down and 10, Street will take it, give it off on the right side, hit at the line, falling forward for a couple of yards, but brings up a fourth down. Vols going to have to punt it away. That was McKinney on the carry.
Well, look at it like this, Tommy. Let's try to be optimistic early in the game. You know, our two positive plays pick up 3.5, 4 yards apiece. If we have a play like that to start the game, we're in a first down right now. So we just shot ourselves in the foot that time. It's hard to overcome a starting play where you put yourself 3 yards behind the original line of scrimmage. Now we need a good punt here out of Harry and able to flip the field and let's play a little defense.
Did a great job punting it last week. This one, low kick, going to be hit and gets a roll to about the 43. That's where Sylacauga will start. First down and 10 when we come back. You're watching Vols football on WAXC-TV.
Service, selection, quality, and value is hard to find all in one package. But the all-new J.D.'s Tire and Lube Center at the Old Voshees location in Alex City delivers. Get full service at the pump with J.D.'s no ethanol fuel and diesel fuel. J.D.'s Tire and Lube offers any brand of tire you can name. With professional installation and fast turnaround, J.D.'s does all your vehicle maintenance work, and you can always expect great service on all we do at a price that delivers value. J.D.'s Tire and Lube in Alex City is the total package for all your vehicle needs.
At Cabinets Direct, we strive to provide top-quality products along with professional and courteous service. As a family-owned and operated company, we have over 40 years of combined experience in cabinetry sales and installation. We offer a wide range of cabinetry with fully customizable options. We also use only locally made products, keeping our money in our community. For more information, give us a call or visit our showroom. Cabinets Direct.
How do I know if my baby sees well? What should my preschooler be able to see? How quickly can a child's vision change? How old is old enough for contact lenses? What is macular degeneration? Is it inherited? How does diabetes cause blindness? If you've got questions, we've got answers. See Dr. James Poole and Dr. Ernest Champion at Family Eye Care, 329-8400. Check yearly, see clearly.
Want a personal car buying experience? Come by Kia of Auburn and see us. We will find you the exact vehicle that you're looking for. Want leather seats or sunroof? You got it. Red, black, or white. The choice is all up to you. We will find you the car of your dreams. You can own a 2015 Kia Sportage LX for $25,183. which includes Kia's 10-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty. Stop by today at 1687 South College Street or shop online at kiaofauburn.com. War Eagle.
Southern Pipe and Supplies, serving Clay, Tallapoosa, and surrounding counties for decades. Not just a great store for plumbing supplies and service, but a showroom and salespeople to help you with your decisions on brand names like Delta Faucets and customized shower systems. Make sure you pick up your heavy-duty and well-insulated K2 coolers. Southern Pipe and Supplies, located on Dable Road in Alexander City. Call 256-234-4235.
Remember when riding a motorcycle meant thinking different? It still does. Star Motorcycles. We build it. You make it your own. Make a star your own now.
Visit Yamaha in Sylacauga on Highway 280, 256-245-2255, or online, yamahaofsylacauga.com.
First down and 10, Sylacauga.
We jump.
Movement. And looks like we moved into the neutral zone. That's going to cost us five.
Well, that's exactly what that's designed to do, and that's just one of those little – it's really a trick play. What it is the line, they get down, but they don't put their hands down, and then at a called signal, maybe shift is what you're supposed to say. That is the rule, actually. They all stand up, and that time, you know, undisciplined play there by who I feel like has been our best defensive lineman, probably one of our better offensive linemen this year in Dawson, but just – you know, a little anxious, trying to get in the backfield.
Looks like they marked off 6 yards after that penalty. Going deep, got his man down there, and incomplete. That time, Walker airing it out. The receiver had gotten behind the coverage. It's incomplete, but if you look across the way, the chains are showing 2nd and 4 after a 5-yard mark off.
Yeah, that's – I don't know. That's just something that we need to call out there as a coach staff, but – what that was a little play action that sucked us up. You know, our secondary has been our leading tacklers, and that's – you see the results of when your secondary has to come up and make tackles, sometimes they're going to get burnt deep.
Eye backfield for the Aggies. Option to the left. Quarterback keeps it, leaps over the pile. He's got a first down and more down to the Volunteer 40-yard line. Jackson Walker, he's a slippery quarterback and able to get the first down of the night for the Aggies.
That was a good read there by Jackson. He chose to pull it on the triple option, and he had it open out here on the outside too. All he had to do was take it to the end or outside linebacker and pitch it, and he probably picked up some good yards, but he makes a good run up the middle and picks up a first down. So good read there by the quarterback.
Back to the eye, handoff right side. Not a whole lot there, and being spun down once again is Ross at the line of scrimmage. Brings up 2nd and 10. Good play. Looked like Marcus Heflin led the way.
Yeah. What that is there, that was a fake handoff to the fullback and then and going back the other way with a tailback. And that's where you got to play your technique as a defensive lineman and as an outside linebacker, staying at home, slow walking that fence if you're an outside linebacker, and making that tackle on the backside. So good job playing technique. Our defense has been really sound as far as technique's been concerned the last couple of games.
2nd down, about 10. Quarterback keeps it again, breaks a tackle, breaks two. He's to the 30-yard line, and he's close to another Sylacauga first down. Jackson Walker, a couple of big first down runs here for the Aggies on this drive.
Well, you know, we've had trouble last week stopping the quarterback running the ball, and it seems to have carried over to this week as they'll pick up another first down. But, I mean, that's all that is just a little read. He reads our linebacker getting blocked at the second level there and keeps it and picks up the first for it. He's a big guy, that quarterback is. He's bigger than I thought he was going to be.
Receivers either way, split backfield back behind Walker. It is 1st down and 10. Handoff up the gut, breaking one tackle, but not the second. But hammering his way down to the 25-yard line is Ross once again. Good positive yardage there on 1st down. It's going to bring up 2nd down, a long 5.
Yeah, just a little blast play there. They fake a toss to the right back and hand it to the left, and he leads right up the gut. And big 73, the left tackle on this side. He's a big guy. And he just blew us off the line of scrimmage that time. They were able to pick up a couple of yards before our middle linebacker came up and made the tackle. So, you know, we got to get a little better surge out of our defensive line right now is one of the big things. We're sort of getting blown off the ball a little bit.
Devin Smith at the tackle spot, 6'2", 300. He is a senior. 2nd and 5 for Sylacauga at the 25-yard line of the Vols. Speed sweep to the right. No, quarterback keeps it. Breaks two tackles, carrying defenders forward all the way down to the 15-yard line, goes Jackson Walker again.
Well, he's a hard runner, and it was a fake speed sweep, and I think that sort of got us off balance, because normally when you see a receiver going in fast motion like that, you can expect that coming. And I think that we sort of anticipated the speed sweep, and when he kept it, we were caught off guard. And when you got a big guy like that, you're going to have to tackle him low. That time we had him up around the shoulders, right around the waist. You got to get down there on them thighs and wrap up and try to twist him down.
First
he's a hard runner.
At the 15-yard line of the Volunteers, Silicaga on the drive. Motion man goes to the far side. Quarterback keeps it, and he'll knock his way down to the 10-yard line.
Well, look right here, Tommy. We're not lining up according to what they're giving us right there. That was just a little wing tee with a split. The outside linebacker's got to come up more and make that tackle. He knows he has the quarterback. Don't wait back on the pitch, man. Come up and make a play right there.
That's another gain of 5 yards. Jackson Walker moves it down to the 10-yard line.
If we don't hit him at the line of scrimmage, he's going to eat us up all night.
He's been very impressive here early. Here's a tight formation. A little double wing set. Unbalanced to the right side. Back with the same look. Walker's got it. Spins forward to about the 9.
And just what he didn't do last play, he does this play. Our outside linebacker comes up and makes a good play at the line of scrimmage. You know, in that double wing tee, they run that just so they can run that option there. You got the one wing, or you got the back to hand it off to as the dive. You got a wing in motion as your pitch man and a quarterback that can run. You know you got to come up on the line of scrimmage as an outside linebacker and be ready to take on that quarterback. That time we get him for a pretty good stop there.
Big third down play here. Third, and we'll call it about 3. Same play to the right side. Quarterback hit in the backfield. No, sir. He'll be stopped and driven back. No gain's going to bring up fourth down and should bring on Riley Keith for the field goal opportunity, you would assume. However,
they don't look like they're.
Silicaga has not sent out the kicker as of yet.
Well, I mean, you know, they've been doing – I mean, it's been a pretty good drive. It's a really important game for them. You got to lay it all out right now. And, you know, they know that we're explosive offensively when we get going, so get as many points as you can. They'll come out in the wishbone now.
Fourth down at about 3. Silicaga will go for it, fakes it, rolls out to the left side. He's got all kinds of real estate to the 5, dumps it, knocked down by Davin Flanord. He had his first down. Yeah. And then throws it. Flanord knocks it down, and that's going to stop the drive.
Well, you know, we got very fortunate that time. That's a good play. First of all, that's a good play from Davin to know that he had a safety behind him. He could roll up and rely on DJ with his speed to come over and help cover. But that quarterback, if he had tucked it, that'd been 6. I mean, there's no other way to put it. That's just a mistake on his part. So, fortunately for us, we come up with a big play there, and we'll have the ball. And we got to get something going offensively now. We shot ourselves in the foot to begin the game, Tommy. We've got to get that flow going. It's all about, for us as an offense, it's about establishing a flow and getting in a rhythm. And when you put yourself in a bind like that, that throws off your rhythm, and you really put yourself at a loss. So we need to come out here and establish a rhythm, pick up a couple of yards per play, and drive the football.
Ball back at the 7. Hand off up the middle. No, actually, Street keeps it now, bounces it off. Street to the 15, Street to the 20, to the 25, to the 27. He's got a gain of 20, does Ben Street, and that's good for a General's Cafe first down.
You know, I talked to Ben's brother, Allen, before the game, and I told him, Allen, you know, I want to see Ben keep it on the zone read a little more and tuck it and run, because in my personal opinion, other than Cameron, who's out for the season, he's our most explosive runner. He's the one that can make the big play with his feet, and he just hasn't really ran it as much as I thought he could. That time he makes a good play. I thought they had him for a loss, but he's able to break out and pick up a lot of yardage, and now we have some operating room here.
Street back to pass, looking deep for DJ Ford. Flips it down there, jump ball, and Ford catches the football.
Yes, sir.
He sure does at the 48-yard line. Huge catch by DJ Ford.
Well, let me say this, too. A great throw by Ben there. He puts it where only DJ can get it, and DJ Mason, absolutely astounding catch. You know, he's going to be able to outjump everybody on the field with the exception of maybe Davin. So he goes up and gets that one at its highest point. Kids that are watching this, that's how you catch the football. Go up and catch it at its highest point like a rebound and bring it down. Make sure you get those feet in bounds.
Street with 2 backs next to him. He'll give it off to Jennings. Goes left side. Finds the corner. Turns it up. Does Jennings. Got a big positive yardage. He's to the 35, to the 30-yard line. J.J. Jennings down to the 27.
Good run, J.J., but that play was sprung by a block from Quan McKinney there at the end. He had his head in good position. They're probably going to call a holding, though, because I think he may have had his – his hand on the back, but he had his head in good position and got the guy reached, and that was able to spring JJ there on the outside. I hope that one don't come back.
Looks like it will be a hold against the Volunteers.
Yeah, I think they're going to call it on Quine. I was saying it was a good block, but he probably had his hand on the back. When you're out there on the edge, Tommy, at the tight end position or a wing or what have you, you got to make sure your hands are inside. Now, you can hold inside, and I played tight end, and that's what I did every play. You can hold inside if you get your hands in good position, but once that hand comes out to the back, you know, that's what the referee's going to see. And even if you aren't holding, if that hand's on the back, they're going to call a hold every time. So you got to make sure you're in good position.
Makes it first and 18. Football resting at the 44-yard line for the Vols. Staying in the spread. Streak. Motion man comes to the near side. He'll keep it. Quarterback draw all the way. Finds a gap midfield. Street will take it to about the 49-yard line. Gain of about 7 brings up a second and 11.
Well, you know, Tommy, here's where that penalty sort of hurt us, because we were moving the ball. It's like we said earlier, the flow. We had the flow going, the rhythm going. What we need now is we're going to have to pick up more yardage per play than we like to, I guess is the way to put it. We like to try to pick up those 3, 4, 5 yards and tack on a 6 or 7 every once in a while with a big play to DJ or Davin. Now, we're going to have to pick up 5 or 6 per play in order to get the first down here. So, you know, penalties will put you in a bind, but it's nothing that we can't overcome with our explosive playmakers on the outside.
Bunch set over here to the near side. Street takes it, goes to Quan McKinney on the left side. McKinney hitting the backfield and brought down at the line. He may have fallen forward for a yard, but it's going to bring up second. Actually, check that, third down and 10.
Well, Quan that time should have followed his lead blocker, Blair Lacey. Had a good block on the linebacker that time. If he hits it up in that hole and follows off Blair's block, he's probably still running because he had plenty of room there, big lane. That's just, you know, inexperience at the running back position, and that's something he'll learn as he gets more carries. But when you see that seam, have faith that your blocker who led up in there the right way, he turned up in that seam. You got to follow him and hit that hole.
Third down, a short 10.
I want to see the slant and go to DJ. Fake the zone read, slant and go.
Street will take the snap, step back, throws it out there to JT Burns. What a catch. Burns falling down, reaches behind him, and he is close to first down yardage. Looks like he may be shy by about a half yard.
Oh, you got to give him that. That's a great catch. And I got to give Burns props and Ben. They knew where the sticks were, and they tried to get as close to him as possible. And that was a little behind him. He made a good catch, but he was running for the first down. So good play by a smart receiver. He's one of the smartest players on the team. I don't know how his grades are, and I'm sure they're probably good.
I'm sure somebody will tell you.
A teacher. But,
and
but,
mom.
Yeah. And so I'm sure they're good, but he's a football smart guy. He really is.
Both of your parents were educators,
both
too, though,
of,
right?
My mom's.
You want to talk about your grades or anything? Or?
Hey, you know, my dad probably would like to.
Fourth down, Vols go for it, pitch it back, lost, and Jennings gets it. He's going to be hit and sacked back near midfield.
Well, you know, that's just not something you can do right there. I mean, you know, we have a half a foot to go. Just bust it up in there and get the first down, you know. Ball security, we said it earlier when we fumbled to start the game. That two fumbles that we've actually recovered ourselves have really just stopped us offensively tonight. You know, the first one puts us in a bind that we can't overcome. That one there prevents us from getting a first down. And, you know, it is what it is. You put the ball on the ground, you're going to get beaten. Right now, it stopped us twice.
Hand off to Thomas. No, actually, he keeps it. Quarterback to the 40-yard line, breaks the tackle. Here's Walker down the near sideline. 15, 10, 5, and dives. They will say he's down at the 1. Blair Lacey trips him up, but Jackson Walker rips off a huge gain for Sylacauga, and now the Aggies are knocking on the door at the 1.
Well, that's a good read again, Tommy. I mean, it's just a little zone read play there, and he had a gap there. We got blocked at the linebacker level. Then we miss a tackle out here at safety, and you know if you miss a tackle at safety, there's nobody else behind you. Fortunately, Blair's able to hawk him down and make a tackle, a touchdown-saving tackle. Now we got to stand up strong defensively here and get a goal line stand.
Hand off up the middle. Thomason will not get there. Second effort still keeps him shy. It's going to bring up second and goal from about the 1.
We'll give credit to our tackles and nose guard there. You know, got a good surge. And when you're playing goal line offense or defense, it's all about being low and getting that surge. And if you can stand up their center and guards like we just did, you're going to stop them 9 times out of 10. And we were fortunate that time that we had a good surge from the defensive line.
Second down and goal. Just outside the 1, Walker hands it off, and into the end zone goes Thomason.
Well, you know, the option, that's what that was, and we haven't really stopped it all night. I mean, if they're not getting us with the dive back, they're getting us with the quarterback, and that's why the option's such a good play, is because you have to play great technique all across the board, or they're going to get you. And so far tonight, we've had trouble stopping it. So, you know, we've got to go in here defensively when we get to the sideline and talk about it as a unit, remind each other of what our responsibility is on the option. And that's how you'll stop it, is playing good technique and remembering your responsibilities.
Keith with the extra point is right through there. Silicaga takes a 7-0 lead. That's your First State Bank score with 1:02 left here in the first. Big run by Jackson Walker. Thomason gets the last yard. Extra point by Keith. And the Vols are down 7-0 with 1:02 remaining in the first. Thanks to all the sponsors who bring you volunteer football. They include JD's Tire and Lube, Southern Pipe and Supply, Monty Albon, as well as Lineville Marathon Food Shop and Central Alabama Community College. Ball's going to have to battle from behind here. They trail by 7 in this big Class 5A Region 3 matchup. Back deep, Malik Dark, as he will return the kick to his right. Looks to be Logan Cooper. Jennings to the far side. Another big kick this time. Jennings inside the 10-yard line. Trying to find the wall, gets to the 10. Cuts it back. He's going to be hit and driven down inside the 20-yard line at about the 16, where the Vols will start first and 10.
Okay, Tommy, last offensive possession, we had a good flow going. You know, we made a couple of mistakes there at the end to stop the drive. We got to continue that. I like the way that we're getting the ball out to DJ and Davin are trying to hit our receivers. We got to keep that up. I like our quick passing game. I think that's our best offense. You know, continue to do that, get a good block out of our good surge there from our line and some good blocks, and I think we'll be okay. Now, it's all about flow and rhythm. No mental mistakes this time. That's what I want to see us do. No mental mistakes here on the offensive side of the ball.
Street shotgun look. Brings the man in motion to the near side. Now we'll roll out to the right side. Looking, got his man deep, throws it. It's going to be tipped and almost picked off. He saw Flanord just like I did. What he didn't see, and neither did I, was the safety drifting over. And that's a great play by number 3, and that is Cade Bryant who breaks it up.
Well, you can tell right now that they're keying on Davin and DJ, and that's why earlier in the ball game when we got that big third down, almost a first down pickup with Burns, is because they had two men apiece on DJ and Davin. So what that is, you got to read that a little better as a receiver. You need to square that off a little earlier. When you know your quarterback's rolling out, square that off and hit that quick pass. Pick up what you can.
Second down and 10, Volunteers. Couple of backs in there. This is Jennings getting the call left side. Got a flag on the play. Jennings will fall forward to the 22-yard line. That's a gain of about 5. But the officials, looks like an illegal procedure call going to go against the Vols. I believe that's going to be too many men in the backfield because everybody called it, and it will cost the Volunteers 5.
Well, mental mistakes, Tommy. I mean, that's our first one this drive. Puts us back a little bit here on second down, back in our own territory. And, you know, that's just something that we've had problems with this year is making mental errors. So, you know, we got to get in there right now and make some mental mistake-free football and get blocking on the second level. I think that we're doing a pretty good job up front of blocking their defensive line. The problem we're having right now is their linebackers when it comes to blocking. So we got to get to that second level and a little better. They're running a little 4-3 scheme. Get to those outside linebackers and seal off that middle, and I think we'll be okay. They're coming with the blitz here.
Street leaves it right side. Out across the 16, maybe the 17-yard line is Jennings. He's going to set up a third down and about 11 yards to go. I believe they'll let this one expire and take it to the second period as they let the clock wind down. Silicaga gets a 1-yard touchdown run from Thomason. Takes a 7-0 lead over the Volunteers. Second period action continues in a moment. This is Vols football on WAXC TV.
First State Bank is a community-owned bank established in 1971 with a mission to be the bank for all people in the area with a primary focus on good old-fashioned customer service. First State Bank has convenient branches located in Lineville, Ashland, and Wedowee. Since its founding, First State Bank has continued to grow and keep up with the banking industry changes in technology to give its customers the best service available, such as internet and mobile banking. First State Bank, here to make dreams come true for people just like you.
For over 30 years, Tallapoosa Ford has been your family-owned auto dealer for hot trucks and SUVs. Now they're raising the bar even higher. The Ford F-150 has been the best-selling truck in America for the last 38 years. And the hot new 15s are hitting the scene, and Tallapoosa Ford and Ford trucks are number one for a reason. America's best truck, combined with our award-winning service department for the region's best warranty work and great maintenance and service.
Hello, this is Jeff with Tallapoosa Ford. Ford trucks have led America's truck sales. Come by today and get your best deal on America's best truck. We don't want all the business, just the opportunity to earn yours.
In a world that's ever changing, you have to be sure that your choices are the right choices. At Central Alabama Community College, you'll know you made the best choice. We understand that you need the best educational opportunities. Whether choosing a technical degree program, taking courses to transfer to a four-year college or university, or being a part of our national championship-winning traditions, Central Alabama will provide you with courses and degree programs in tune with today's workplace. Get a sharper focus on your life by choosing one of our three convenient locations, Alex City, Childersburg, and Talladega. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
We are a debt relief agency. We help people file Chapter 7 and Chapter 13 under the bankruptcy code.
Marcia Mason is pleased to announce the new location of Mason Law Firm at 217 Madison Street in Alexander City. Marcia Mason is your local attorney for bankruptcy and Social Security disability. Call your hometown attorney, Marcia Mason, at 256-329-1313. All initial consultations are free and strictly confidential.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be provided is greater than that of other attorneys.
Over the years, S&S Tire has grown into the Lake Martin area's largest volume tire dealer. S&S Tire offers the industry's best brand names, Michelin, Goodyear, BF Goodrich, Uniroyal, Firestone, and much, much more. The tire pros at S&S offer professional installation and the region's best price. In addition to your tire needs, S&S offers full automotive mechanical work for all your vehicle maintenance and repair needs with the area's most experienced staff. Visit either of our two locations on Cherokee Road in Ellic City or at South Street in Dadeville. At S&S Tire, we're installing peace of mind for every customer we serve. Every job, every day.
Scooter's Grill in Hagnable is serving up some good old-fashioned cooking. Scooter's Grill has a hot buffet with meats and all your favorite home-cooked sides every Tuesday through Thursday from 11 to 1 and 5 to 7. Steak specials are every Friday and Saturday with a ribeye, salad bar, baked potatoes for only $16.99. Of course, all your southern favorites like your pork chops, hamburger steaks, catfish, and much more, including the famous Scooter's Burger with Scooter's secret sauce. So load up the family, get to Scooter's Grill for the best food at affordable prices in Hagnable. Good food, good friends, good times.
Purchasing a new home is easier than you think, and America's Home Place can show you the way. For over 41 years, we've built thousands of homes for people just like you. We guide you through the entire process from purchasing a lot, finding financial options, to putting the finishing touches on your beautiful new house. Come tour our showroom and see over 100 customizable floor plans. Visit us online at americashomeplace.com/TV for a free floor plan book. America's Home Place. We make building easy.
Back at Volunteer Stadium. Second period action to the wishbone we go. Third down and about 11. They'll run the sweep to the near side, trying to get to the corner, to the 20. Diving out close to the 24-yard line is Jennings. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Well, he's one block away from getting a first down, and the block was out here on the receiver. And that's just – it's. I know Davin plays basketball, and that's who the receiver was. It's basketball defense, and it's just getting your feet in position and getting between – the man and the ball carrier, and we just didn't do it that time. That's a big play right there, and you know that it's a big play. Make a good block on a big play.
Dawson Harry in punt formation. Falls down one player. Final one skips on. Silicaga stands to get some pretty good field position. Unless Harry can get a boomer out of here. Not too bad if it'll roll, but the fair catch called for and made it midfield. Tell you what, very smart play there. If that hits the ground, it's going to be a great roll. But Silicaga starts right at midfield here on their drive here in the second period.
Well, you know, the way that Harry kicks the ball, or punts the ball, I should say, is it's going to get a good roll. It's not going to be long in the air, sort of a line drive look, but it's going to roll forward in the ball's favor 9 times out of 10. So you got to think that maybe the Sylacauga coaching staff told them to play up a little bit and catch that punt, try to fair catch it. Now they're in good field position. What we got to stop here is the quarterback running the ball, and we got to stop the triple option. You know it's coming.
Jackson Walker. And gives it, hit, lost in the backfield. The ball is up. It's going to be recovered by the Vols. That is going to be Smith getting the recovery. Not sure who jarred the football loose.
I can tell you who jarred it loose. The outside linebacker, JT Lett, he made a great play there. I don't know if he was on a stun or a blitz, but he read that perfectly and hit the quarterback right when he was handing it off or pitching it. Made a great play right there. Give JT the credit for that play. And, you know, I thought we was going to scoop and score, but now we give our offense a little momentum. We've got great field position, Tommy. We got to get in a rhythm right now. Moving the football, mental mistake-free football right now. And let's see if something happens. I like this little bunch package here.
Back to pass is straight. Going to throw it deep for DJ. Down in there, DJ goes up and can't haul it in. Trying to make a leaping catch inside the 20. It is incomplete. Second and 10.
Well, here's the good reason for that formation. The reason I said I liked it is because when you have four over here, you have no choice but to isolate or either try to put a linebacker on DJ. And that leaves a mismatch. Now, he could have caught that ball. I thought that was an easier catch to make than the one he made on our sideline. Not a terrible, terrible thrown ball. Decent coverage, though. But I like that formation. I hope that we come back to that later in the football game because it gives us a chance to isolate our best player on a backup corner.
Second down and 10. Street rolls out to the near side. Looking, going to tuck it under and try to run. Tries to get inside the 40. He will to the 38-yard line. Gain of a yard, maybe two, but it's going to set up a third down, and we'll say about 7.5.
Well, you know, that was a rolling pocket that time. He had good protection. I thought maybe he should have set his feet and tried to see if Davin would come back to him and get open. But, you know, I can live with that play. good job blocking up front by the left side of that offensive line on that rolling pocket. So, not a bad play.
Vols going to take the timeout. We'll keep it right here with 10:49 left here in the first half. 7-0, your First Aid Bank score. Sylacauga leading over the Central Vols. And again, thanks to all the sponsors who bring you volunteer football each and every week. Kia of Auburn, Marilyn Mason, or check that, Marcia Mason, attorney at law. Red's Catfish Cabin, also S&S Tire, and Yamaha of Sylacauga.
Thinking of a little rock and roll there?
I was thinking a rock and roll theme, and I'll just steer clear of that one. I don't know where that came from. Volunteers trying to stop the quarterback. Been a tough couple of weeks trying to corral those young men. And I tell you, Jackson Walker, he is a slippery quarterback to get through that line and make some big things happen.
He is, and he's got good size. And the thing about him that works so well for him is that he reads that option very well. He hasn't misread a play tonight, I don't think, that I can remember. So when you got a quarterback that's got fairly good athleticism, good size, and reads well, it's hard to stop that option.
Little diamond set here for the Volunteers. Four wideouts go to the right.
And that's why.
And DJ to the left all alone. I like the look. Street steps back, throws the deep slant to DJ. Can't hold on. Had it at about the 16. And could not pull it in. It's going to bring up fourth down.
You know, and their secondary is back there celebrating and everything. And, you know, kudos to him. He dropped the ball, but that was nothing that they did because he burnt that guy and was wide open. So, great throw by Ben Street. You got to catch that ball. You know, I'm sort of thinking, Tommy, maybe run that same formation but put Davin over there because Davin's got a little bit better hands. They're similar athleticism. Let's see what happens. But that was a good formation because it isolates them. On that receiver.
Harry
that corner.
Punts it out of there. Low. Going to hit at the 10. Roll inside the 5. Can they save it? Zach Horn tried to, and they say, yes, he did at the 1. Somehow, Zach Horn kept it out of the end zone. Wow, what a play by Popcorn.
That's just a hustle play. I mean, I go back and watch the replay on that. He's running full speed down there after that ball. He does a good job of finding it. And the difference in professional football, and I think even college and high school, is that even if your body goes in the end zone, but the football doesn't, you're down where the football is. So, you know, good play by Popcorn, heads up play to find the football. Now, you know, we need to dial up maybe a stun or a blitz here. I like what we did with Lett earlier. Do that again, get them here for a loss or get them for a safety, and we'll be on the board.
Back at the 1 yard line. After the great play by Zach Horn.
And they're going shotgun here on the goal line. They'll shift out of it.
Shift and go to the eye. Dotting the eye. And calling a timeout here. A little indecision by Sylacauga there. They will take the timeout. 10:20 remaining here in the first half. Gives us an opportunity to talk about next week's action. It is a Thursday night game being played at Talladega. The Volunteers are on the road due to race weekend. The Talladega schools always play on Thursday, so we will have a Thursday night special coming up next week as we will be over at the home of the Tigers. They've had a tough season, but I'm going to tell you, they are also a very explosive group with a lot of athletes.
Well, it's a game that you got to come out and play good. I mean, you know, you got to come out and you can't turn the ball over. It's a game that we should win, let's be honest about it. And it's a game I expect us to win. If we want to do anything deep into the playoffs, it's a game that we have to win, you know. But come out, play good, sound, secure football, and we should come away with a win. And it's always fun traveling down to Talladega County on a race weekend.
We'll stay away from there, though. First down and 10. Sylacauga's got it back at their own one-yard line. Walker, the quarterback, will switch again back to the eye. Ross dots the eye.
Watch the fullback.
Behind and movement.
That's what
at
they
the
were
nose. Trying to get the jump, and they are able to get out of the hole. That's going to cost us 5 and move it out to the 6.
Look, I love Malik. He's a great player. You're right in front of the football, Tommy. You're right over the football. You shouldn't even be listening. You should be deaf to everything going on except for maybe the sound of the linebacker behind you, you know, if he's telling you to shift or something. But you're watching that football. If you're playing defense, you don't go off sound. You go off movement. You go off motion. So watch that football, and when it moves, then you fire off.
Makes it 1st and 5. Quarterback keeps it. Reaching out to the 11-yard line. That looks good for a first down for Walker again. He is close to first down yardage. And I believe he has reached it.
Yeah.
They'll say shy of the first down. Okay. Shy by about a football length.
Our linebacker's got to get hit up in there a little harder on that quarterback. You should be cross-keying, so that should be, if they lined up like this last time, that should be Tyler. You got to hit up in there hard and get that quarterback. You know he's running it.
Hands it off left side. Big gainer across the 20 out to the 21-yard line.
Number 5, Alex.
That's Thomason on the carry there. That's good for Sylacauga first down. So from their own one and a couple plays, Aggies have reached out across the 20.
Yeah, and we got kicked out there at the outside linebacker position. Big 73, the left tackle, just drove our outside linebacker off the ball. It opened up a big hole, and we didn't fill it from the linebacker position, middle linebacker.
Back it goes left side, Thomason. He is drilled over on the far side. That's a big hit. I believe Flanord will get the pop over there, but Thomason falls forward for about 3.5 to 4.
Yeah, and it was the same thing. I mean, we got kicked out again at the outside linebacker position and missed a tackle over there, I believe, and we held him up long enough, I think, for Davin to come in and make a good play, but, you know, just got to hold our own there at the outside linebacker position. Put the freshman in at nose guard now.
Bass is in there. Eye backfield for the Aggies. Rolling out, dumps it off. It's going to be knocked out of there. Almost picked off by Smith. That time pretty much gave that one away. Tried to hit Thomason short, and it brings up 3rd down about 6.
Well, I have confidence in our secondary because we've had some good coverage tonight, Tommy, and I'll give it to Smith. You know, he's a pretty good run stopper, but he's a really good in coverage. I mean, and looking at him, you wouldn't think that, but he does a good job of dropping back and picking up those backs out of the backfield in the curl in the little short hook zone there, a little out. He made a good play there. I thought he was going to pick it.
Third down and about 6. Going to look out in the flats. Catch is going to be knocked out of there. And picking it off is going to be Smith. 35-yard line. 30 is Tyler Smith. Breaks the tackle at the 25. He'll take it to the 19-yard line.
I think that was Davin that came in right at the last second. I thought we were going to give up the hitch there. I mean the slant there. But he came in at the last second and punched it out. And it punched it up in the air. And Tyler heads up play, turned around, and made a good catch there. Secured it and took it back for a couple of yards now. You know, they've given us opportunity last time. They're giving us an opportunity here. We've got to capitalize on these opportunities when they're given to us, Tommy, because this is a huge game, and they're not going to come. They're going to be few and far between. So we got to capitalize when we get the chance.
2 turnovers for the Volunteers deep in Sylacauga territory. We're yet to get on the board. Street gives it off to McKinney. Bounces outside. He's hit. Did he lose it? I believe he did. I don't know if we got back on it out there at about the 22-yard line. Looks like a good job by Blair Lacy to recover the fumble.
Well, you know what that was, Tommy, penetration that we didn't pick up. And that's something we've had trouble with all night or all year long is picking up that slant from the defensive line and sometimes the linebackers coming through. But that time, defensive line had a little slant on. We didn't get our head across at all, and that time he hits us in the backfield. There's nothing Quan can do about that. But the little criticism for him, you got to secure the football.
Davin Flanord comes to the near side. Ford goes to the far side. Second and long as Street drops back, looking, throws it into flats to DJ, makes the catch. He'll stretch forward, loses it.
He's down.
They'll say he was down. The ground caused the fumble at about the 15.
You know, and that's what I love to see us run. And I've said it before, that's our best play. We run two short comebacks over here on both sides. He gets to choose which side he wants. He goes with the backup corner, which is a smart play. DJ secures the ball, brings it in, picks up good yardage. Now we're in a manageable third down here.
We'll call it third down at about six. JT Burns checks in. A lot of times on third and medium, that's your target right there. He'll split out to the right side. Flanord comes to the near side. Again, the shotgun look. Street will take it. Gives it off to Heflin up the middle. Not a lot there. I don't believe he got there. He did not. He will bring it up to fourth down, and it looks like about a yard and a half to two. Balls look like they're going to go for it here.
Yeah, I was going to say, we're going for it here. I mean, you fourth and two, it's a big game. I think we're going to probably go in the bone, it looks like. Oh, maybe not. I thought we were bringing out our receivers, but putting DJ back in, maybe a split bone. We'll see.
Fourth and a couple. A little confusion. And still not sure of where to line up. Now
you're,
the unbalanced,
unbalanced, yeah.
Unbalanced left side. Wishbone set on fourth and a couple. Street runs a sweep to the left side. Cutting it up. It's going to be close. No.
Mm-mm.
Did not get there. Silicaga gets the stop.
Well, you know, it's a little toss to the left side, lead toss, or a power toss is what we used to call it. You got two lead blockers out of the fullback in the halfback. We didn't do a good job of getting their line blocked that time. Their defensive line is what caused that tackle. They push us in the backfield, make us deviate from our intended path. You got to hit that one up in there, though, a little harder, I think, inside and pick up what you can. But big play from a Silicaga defense there.
Couple of turnovers in Silicaga territory lead to no points. We're still sitting with the goose egg on the scoreboard. Silicaga with the football. Walker goes left side, not a lot there. It's going to bring up second down and long.
And there's two things I want to point out on this play, Tommy. Number one, the linebacker did a good job of hitting the hole and getting the dive. Number two, and this had nothing to do with the tackle, but Blair Lacy on the outside hit their pitch man and took him to the ground and hit him hard. That's how you stop the option. You make him know that you're out there so that when he's thinking about getting that pitch and looking at the quarterback, he's also thinking, well, hey, 87's about to put his helmet under my chin. That's how you stop that from happening.
Second down and 10. Option, pitch it back.
Good
and
tackle.
Being chopped down. Good tackle there. Smith again. Right at the 15-yard line. He'll gain a yard, maybe two, but it sets up third down and eight.
Well,
good stop.
If you'll look, they have a number 87 receiver who's a lot bigger than most normal receivers you see.
220.
When they run that double slot, you got to think that maybe the option, the pitch is coming that way because he's trying to block that linebacker from getting on the pitch, man. That time we did a good job of getting off that block and cutting him back up inside a little bit or making him deviate a little bit so Tyler had time to come out there and chop him down. Good tackle.
Third and five. Walker back, throws it deep, got a man, can't complete it. A little overthrown. We'll set up fourth and five, and now Silicaga going to have to punt the football away.
Yeah, good defensive stand there for the Volunteers. You know, one thing, and we said it, DJ, he likes to come up and make tackles. You got to be aware, though, that you can't get burnt deep. So, but I can live with that play. I thought we had fairly decent coverage. You'd have to make a really good throw for them to hit that one, and there's not many quarterbacks in high school that are going to be able to do that. So, you know, good defensive stand there for the Volunteers.
But a couple of times, like you said, you've seen the receiver split defenders and get a step. If he floats it up a little bit more, Aggies are in the end zone
again.
Yeah,
that's true.
Good punt. Jennings fair catch called for and made. We'll start inside Silicaga territory at about the 48-yard line.
Good field position here, Tommy. And, you know, twice we've been in their position, in their side of the field. We've got to capitalize.
5 minutes, 12 seconds left here in the first half. 7-0 our score. Sylacauga up by a touchdown. 1 yard touchdown run by Thomason. Gets them on the board. This time, looks like Morgan, DJ to the right side, Flanord and Zachary to the near side. Street, quick hitch out here to Ladarius Zachary. He's to the 40-yard line. Zachary takes it inside the 40 to about the 36-yard line. That is good for a Vol first down.
I like the initial first step inside, but after you go inside for one step and you see Coach Franklin Few down here, the receivers coach telling him that, hit the outside sideline and read your block and go. There's 10 other people out inside. There's one outside that you have to make miss. Hit the outside and go. You had a good block out here from Davin that time.
Street with a shotgun. It's first down and 10 for the Vols. He'll take it. Give it off. McKinney comes left side, following his blockers to the 30. McKinney hammers his way down to about the 27-yard line. Good run.
Good lead, good pull from 50, the right guard, Neil Anderson, that time, and a good block from 59. You'll watch it on the film. He gets to the second level and drives that linebacker back, makes a good block, and picks up good yardage there.
And a great play by McKinney to get in the back pocket and just follow his blocker through the hole.
And that's
great job.
That's something we've had trouble doing tonight, but there you see McKinney do it, and I really like that. And that shows the sign that he's learning to trust his blockers more and read those blocks a little better.
Street, second down and one. Street keeps it left side, hitting the backfield, falls forward. I don't think he got his first down. If he did, it's not by much. They'll stop it, stopping the clock here with 4:12 remaining in the first half. That time just a quarterback keeper to the left side, and may have to measure this one.
Well, you know, we pulled the guard, and we pulled, I think, a wing or an end. I didn't see where Blair lined up, but he pulled. And, you know, you don't really pull a lot if you're an end or a wing, so he didn't really do a good job of picking up the penetration as well as he should have. Sometimes you have an assigned man when you get over there, but you have to deviate and pick up penetration. He was looking for that assigned man and didn't see the penetration, and that's what sort of stopped us there that time. He's got to get his head up and pick up penetration. But, you know, not a bad rim play there.
It is third down and one. Shotgun look for the Vols. Everybody in the comes up close for Sylacauga. Street, keeper, left side, got his first down, lowers his shoulder and takes it to about the 20-yard line. Good run by Street. That's good for a General's Cafe first down.
Well, you know, and I'm not one to ever question coaching, but I feel like that's what we should have did on the in the first quarter when we had it fourth and short instead of running the toss. Ben's a big guy, and I know he's valuable and you don't want to get him hurt, but he's going to pick up the first down if it's within a yard, you got to think, you know, unless some big play happens. But, you know, good run there, good call.
Timeout on the field. Sylacauga will take the timeout. 7-0, your First State Bank score. Thanks to all the sponsors bringing you volunteer football, including Dairy Delight. Discover what everyone's talking about. Highway 77 just off the Ashland Square. We'll take this timeout. This is Vols Football on WAXC-TV.
Cabinets Feed and Farm Supply on the corner of Highway 280 and Quarry Road in Sylacauga is Central Alabama's complete feed and farm supply headquarters with full feed lines for horses, cattle, and pets from Purina, Nutrina, and Pennington. And if you're gearing up for hunting season, make sure to get all your clover and deer mixes. Need more space or own your own hunting club? Find full lines of Cotton State buildings at Cabinets and free delivery for 50 miles and relaxed financing. Get all your land, farm, and feed needs from Cabinets Feed and Farm on Highway 280 in Sylacauga.
General's Cafe in Newsite is the area's number one place for great food with great people. General's Cafe has only the best home-cooked food served hot and fresh and is sure to feed your appetite. General's has everything from the delicious fish plate to big juicy steaks. Come in every day for lunch and get the daily special, which will fill your belly and save you money. When you're looking for a good meal in a family-friendly atmosphere, then make the short drive out to General's Cafe on Highway 22 East in Newsite.
You may know them from high school, from the local grocery store, or even your own neighborhood. These local teens have embarked on a new journey, one that begins at Southern Union State Community College. Visit suscc.edu/journey to see the life's journey these students have planned. We believe that you have an amazing journey ahead of you too, and Southern Union is the perfect place to begin at an affordable price close to home. Southern Union, where the journey begins.
Remember when riding a motorcycle meant thinking different? It still does. Star Motorcycles. We build it.
you make it your own. Make a Star your own now.
Visit Yamaha of Sylacauga on Highway 280, 256-245-2255, or online, yamahaofsylacauga.com.
Red's Catfish Cabin in Crackford, Alabama is adding tailgate specials just for you. Hot wings, mile wings, you can buy one or 200. Get with Larry and the crew at 256-354-7705. Now, they still going to have that delicious catfish that they're known for, sweet tea, which they're known for, and everything else. If you've never eaten at Red's Catfish Cabin, I want you to go today. That's in Crackford, Alabama.
To throw the hanky, evidently.
Yeah.
And we're down to 23 seconds left here in the first half. That'll move it back five.
You know, I say take a shot, Tommy. I mean, you know, we ran a couple of minutes off the clock there and get nothing for it. But, I mean, take a shot. That's my personal opinion. But we do get the ball back the second half, so.
Two wideouts will go to the right. You've got DJ all alone over there.
Press man on him.
Hand off to Heflin up the middle and back to the line and nothing more.
That'll do it for the half.
That is the end of the first half. The Volunteers trailing the Aggies 7-0. That's your First Aid Bank score. We'll be back with your Cabinets Direct halftime report in just a moment. This is Vols Football on WAXC TV.
At Cabinets Direct, we strive to provide top quality products along with professional and courteous service. As a family-owned and operated company, we have over 40 years of combined experience in cabinetry sales and installation. We offer a wide range of cabinetry with fully customizable options. We also use only locally made products, keeping our money in our community. For more information, give us a call or visit our showroom, Cabinets Direct.
First State Bank is a community-owned bank established in 1971 with a mission to be the bank for all people in the area with a primary focus on good old-fashioned customer service. First State Bank has convenient branches located in Lineville, Ashland, and Wedowee. Since its founding, First State Bank has continued to grow and keep up with the banking industry changes in technology to give its customers the best service available, such as internet and mobile banking. First State Bank, here to make dreams come true for people just like you.
For over 35 years, Dairy Delight in Ashland has been providing the area some of the best of your favorite comfort food. From the best burgers around to their famous hot dogs and chicken fingers and sandwiches, even the pickiest of eaters can find some great food at Dairy Delight. And never leave without getting one of the hand-spun milkshakes, banana splits, or soft-serve ice cream just to top it off. Visit Dairy Delight on Highway 77 North, just off the square in downtown Ashland, to discover what everyone's talking about and become a customer for life.
Want a personal car buying experience? Come by Kia of Auburn and see us. We will find you the exact vehicle that you're looking for. Want leather seats or sunroof? You got it. Red, black, or white. The choice is all up to you. We will find you the car of your dreams. You can own a 2015 Kia Sportage LX for $25,183, which includes Kia's 10-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty. Stop by today at 1687 South College Street or shop online at kiaofauburn.com. War Eagle.
The best Mexican dining experience around is found at Monte Alban Mexican Restaurant. Real authentic Mexican cuisine and atmosphere awaits you at Monte Alban, with great specials on popular dishes such as the pollo asado and beef or chicken chimichangas. Choose from select dinner or lunch combinations, and you can buy one and get one half off. Want to celebrate your birthday? Get a free drink, meal, and dessert when you dine in. Two convenient locations on the Court Square in Ashland and on Highway 9 in Lineville to serve you.
Central High School Marching Volunteers.
And welcome back to Volunteer Stadium as part of the Cabinets Direct Halftime Report. It's time to sit back and enjoy the Central High School Volunteer Marching Band. This year's show is entitled Fuego. The Vols drum major is Alden Gwynn and features 20 seniors. The Marching Vols have proven to be one of the top bands in the area throughout this fall. Under first-year director Stephen Arline, the Marching Vols have claimed many superior ratings at competitions around the state. Many of the Marching Volunteer Band will be joining with Sylacauga High and B.B. Comer to travel to Chicago for the 2015 Magnificent Mile Lights Festival parade coming up in November. Now, let's enjoy the Central High School Volunteer Marching Band.
We'll be right back.
And that's the 2015 Central High School Marching Band here at halftime. Our score at the half, 7-0. Sylacauga leading over the Volunteers. When we come back, we'll continue with our Cabinets Direct halftime report. It comes your way in just a moment.
For over 30 years, Tallapoosa Ford has been your family-owned auto dealer for hot trucks and SUVs. Now they're raising the bar even higher. The Ford F-150 has been the best-selling truck in America for the last 38 years. And the hot new 15s are hitting the scene. And Tallapoosa Ford and Ford trucks are number one for a reason. America's best truck, combined with our award-winning service department for the region's best warranty work and great maintenance and service.
Hello, this is Jeff with Tallapoosa Ford. Ford trucks have led America's truck sales. Come by today and get your best deal on America's best truck. We don't want all the business, just the opportunity to earn yours.
Young's Drugstore has proudly served the citizens of Lineville and the surrounding areas for more than 50 years, providing fast, friendly service. At Young's Drugstore, you're more than just a number, which is why we strive to always greet you with a warm hello and friendly smile. Young's Drugstore offers a convenient drive-through window, prescription compounding, vaccination services, and after-hours emergency availability to better serve you. Young's Drugstore now even has the convenience of viewing and refilling your prescriptions online at youngsdrugstorellc.com. Young's Drugstore, located on Highway 9 in Lineville, 256-396-5632. In a world that's ever-changing, you have to be sure that your choices are the right choices. At Central Alabama Community College, you'll know you made the best choice. We understand that you need the best educational opportunities. Whether choosing a technical degree program, taking courses to transfer to a four-year college or university, or being a part of our national championship-winning traditions, Central Alabama will provide you with courses and degree programs in tune with today's workplace. Get a sharper focus on your life by choosing one of our three convenient locations, Alex City, Childersburg, and Talladega. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
Red's Catfish Cabin in Crackford, Alabama is adding tailgate specials just for you. Hot wings, bio wings, you can buy one or 200. Get with Larry and the crew at 256-354-7705. Now, they're still going to have that delicious catfish that they're known for, sweet tea, which they're known for, and everything else. If you've never eaten at Red's Catfish Cabin, I want you to go today. That's in Crackford, Alabama.
Southern Pipe and Supplies, serving Clay, Tallapoosa, and surrounding counties for decades. Not just a great store for plumbing supplies and service, but a showroom and salespeople to help you with your decisions on brand names like Delta Faucets and customized shower systems. Make sure you pick up your heavy-duty and well-insulated K2 coolers. Southern Pipe and Supplies, located on Dable Road in Alexander City. Call 256-234-4235.
Are you sure we should take this billboard down?
People find out State Farm does car loans as well as they do insurance. Our bank is through.
Good point. Grab an edge.
Look, there's two guys on the State Farm Borrow Better Banking sign.
No, for real, there's two dudes on the State Farm
Borrow Better Banking sign.
Gentlemen, please get down from the State Farm Borrow Better Banking sign.
Phil, get the hose.
Okay, he's getting the hose.
All right, let's go.
Want to borrow better? Contact State Farm agent Mike Coleman about a car loan that can save you hundreds.
Welcome back, Cabinets Direct Halftime Report. Tommy Wood, David Burkhalter. We are at half, 7-0. It is Sylacauga leading over the Central Volunteers here at Volunteer Stadium. You see the guys warming up there in the second half. And speaking of warming up, I think that Adam and you and I have all decided that we need to warm up in the second half.
That's right.
It's kind of a little chilly here on top of the old press box.
Well, it's football weather, Tommy, you know, and it's getting that time of the year, and it's only going to go down from here. So get your gloves, maybe some hot hands, and just get ready, buddy.
Speaking of hot hands, we've got to find a way to find a hot hand in the second half to get some points on the board. The Volunteers offensively really struggling here in the first half.
Yeah.
Again, a couple of good turnovers. You think you got an opportunity to make something happen, and just unable to get anything going offensively. We're sitting there at zero, only, I guess, what, one touchdown in the last seven quarters of play.
Well, you know, Tommy, right now the name of the game and the reason we're getting beat 7-0 is missed opportunities. We've had two good field positions handed to us by Sylacauga with turnovers, and then we've dropped passes. We've gotten penalties. We've put the ball on the ground and gotten tackled for a loss, and we just haven't capitalized when given opportunities. And that's something I think we'll remedy in the second half. You know, our best players, no doubt, are our receivers, DJ and Davin. We got to get the ball in their hands, and I like the way I like the defense that Sylacauga has given us for our offense, if that makes sense. I mean, they're playing our best receivers isolation in some scenarios, so we can exploit that this second half. We just got to be able to pull the ball in when we throw it to them. Got to make a good throw. Of course, there was an underthrown ball that resulted in a turnover over here in the end zone for Ben, but, you know, that's going to happen when you have a young quarterback. This half, we need to really do a good job of securing the football. We need to run to open up the pass, and when we get the pass, we got to catch it. And that's the name of the game this half.
We will get the opening kickoff of the second half when we come back. Again, that's your Cabinets Direct halftime reporter. We appreciate their sponsorship throughout the season. When we come back, it's time for second half action. Sylacauga leading over our Volunteers 7-0. We'll be back in just a moment. This is Vols Football on WAXC TV.
Service, selection, quality, and value is hard to find all in one package, but the all-new JD's Tire and Lube Center at the Old Voshees location in Alex City delivers. Get full service at the pump with JD's no ethanol fuel and diesel fuel. JD's Tire and Lube offers any brand of tire you can name. With professional installation and fast turnaround, JD's does all your vehicle maintenance work, and you can always expect great service on all we do at a price that delivers value. JD's Tire and Lube in Alex City is the total package for all your vehicle needs.
How do I know if my baby sees well? What should my preschooler be able to see? How quickly can a child's vision change? How old is old enough for contact lenses? What is macular degeneration? Is it inherited? How does diabetes cause blindness? If you've got questions, we've got answers. See Dr. James Poole and Dr. Ernest Champion at Family Eye Care, 329-8400. Check yearly, see clearly.
Lineville Health and Rehab in Lineville, Alabama has a staff and has had a staff of caring folks for years. If it has come that time in life for that person in your family to look at the possibility of going into a health and rehab facility, you have a choice. You have a choice to choose, and the fine folks at Lineville Health and Rehab would like to take this time to invite you by to meet them and them you. Caring folks that care for you and your family. You have a choice. The number to call is 256-396-2104.
You may know them from high school, from the local grocery store, or even your own neighborhood. These local teens have embarked on a new journey, one that begins at Southern Union State Community College. Visit suscc.edu/journey to see the life's journey these students have planned. We believe that you have an amazing journey ahead of you, too. And Southern Union is the perfect place to begin at an affordable price close to home. Southern Union, where the journey begins.
Southern Pipe and Supplies, serving Clay, Tallapoosa, and surrounding counties for decades. Not just a great store for plumbing supplies and service, but a showroom and salespeople to help you with your decisions on brand names like Delta Faucets and customized shower systems. Make sure you pick up your heavy-duty and well-insulated K2 coolers. Southern Pipe and Supplies, located on Dable Road in Alexander City. Call 256-234-4235.
Over the years, S&S Tire has grown into the Lake Martin area's largest volume tire dealer. S&S Tire offers the industry's best brand names, Michelin, Goodyear, BF Goodrich, Uniroyal, Firestone, and much, much more. The tire pros at S&S offer professional installation and the region's best price. In addition to your tire needs, S&S offers full automotive mechanical work for all your vehicle maintenance and repair needs with the area's most experienced staff. Visit either of our two locations on Cherokee Road in Ellic City or at South Street in Dadeville. At S&S Tire, we're installing peace of mind for every customer we serve. Every job, every day.
Sylacauga to kick it off to open up the second half. Going to be Jennings fielding at the 10-yard line. 15-yard line is Jennings. Cuts it
good
back.
Hole.
Gets a little hole. 30-yard line. 35, 40, 45, and across midfield into Sylacauga territory. J.J. Jennings returns the second half kick.
Great blocking there on the left side of the return team, and J.J. finds that seam and picks up some good. That's exactly what we needed to start this half. Got the momentum on our side now. We need to get this crowd into it, get pumped up, make some good plays here offensively, and get something going, and we'll be right back in this thing. I got a good feeling about this second half, Tommy.
Vols will come to the line. Two receivers go left. Two will come to the right. Street, the quarterback, first down and 10. He'll take it. Quick hitch on the outside. Catch is made by Zachary. Zachary runs over defenders. 35. He will bounce his way down to the 30-yard line. Ladarius Zachary, tough running.
Well, you know, they're playing off him there because he's the inside receiver. They're trying to play over the top to prevent us from burning him deep, and that opens that play up right there. All that is just a little seam pass and picks up good. I still want to see him try to bounce that out to the outside and pick up more yardage, but good run there, hard run, giving him head and shoulders when he makes contact and picks up a good first down. We're moving the ball now. No mental mistakes here.
First down and 10, just outside the 30-yard line. Street will take it. Gives it off to Jennings. Jennings lowers a shoulder and takes it inside the 30 to about the 28-yard line.
All right, we pull the left guard, and I mean the right guard and the right tackle, Neil Anderson and Adam Brown. They do a good job of turning up and finding somebody to block. Now, I thought J.J. Mayes should have bounced it off their run to the fanny, as they say. You got to bounce it off their hiney and hit it to the outside, and he'd have picked up a little more yards, but a good offensive play there, and it was because we had good pulling guard and tackle that time.
Second down and about 7. Street brings the man in motion to the near side. That is Flanord. Quick pitch out to Jennings, trying to get to the corner. Jennings bouncing off defenders, and he'll spin his way down to the 21-yard line, shy of the first down. Brings up third and a 1, maybe 2 yards to go.
Good job, hard running there from Jennings, and you see – you see Davin Patton himself that time. That's because he missed the block there on the outside. They put him in motion. They want him to turn up and find somebody to block. That time he sort of hesitated on who he should block. Pick somebody and block. That's all you got to do. But a good hard run by Jennings. He's really running with a head full of steam right now.
Third down, about a yard and a half. Possession down. It's McKinney. Actually, Street keeps it right side. Hits, dives inside the 20 to about the 19. And that is good for a General's Cafe first down.
Good blocking up front, Tommy. The center that time had some good had a good block and pushed his man off the ball. Picked up the first down off the backs of those linemen, and that's what we need right now. We got to keep this drive going. Now here's the thing: we've sort of struggled in the red zone. When we get inside the 20, probably definitely inside the 10, we've struggled. Now we need to keep this momentum alive and make some good plays here. Isolation out there on the outside.
Street with a shotgun look. He'll take it. Hand it off. Up the middle is Heflin fighting for yardage. And he will go down at about the 15-yard line. A gain of about 3, maybe 4.
Churn those legs, baby. Pick up every yard you can because right now they're super important. You got to get every inch that you can fight for because you want to get to those sticks. If you get to the first down marker, you got first and goal from inside the 10. So, you know, we don't have to pick up a touchdown necessarily right here, right now, but let's work it down the rest of this red zone here and get close to the goal line. Then we'll just run that ball on in. But you see him splitting the receivers way outside this time. Could be something to the outside there.
Street will take it. Option left. Turns it up. A lot of green grass. 10-5. Touchdown, Volunteers.
Hey, it started when he made the outside linebacker miss there. It looked like he slipped down, but I'm going to say it was a good move by Ben. He saw that, read it very well, decided to tuck it and run, and an easy 6 for Ben Street.
They split the receiver far to the left, and when he came around the corner, there's nobody home, and Street takes it into the end zone. We're within an extra point of tying it up.
Yeah, when you see the receiver split that far outside, you got to think that it's going to be a run to that side. He's splitting him out for a reason. That's so that corner has to come all the way out there. That's one less tackle. They almost blocked it.
Somehow. Harry gets it up and through, and we are tied at 7 after the touchdown run of about 15 yards for Ben Street. And we are knotted up. New ball game, 9:29 left here in the third.
Hey, we got a ball game on our hands, Tommy. We're not out of this.
Tied up at 7. Volunteer fans, something to cheer about as Ben Street gets the touchdown run.
And that's a look at the future, Tommy. That's what we're going to do for years to come. We're going to keep running the ball with Ben. You got to think, you know, when Cameron Peoples comes back next year, that's going to be a big part of our offense is that little zone read and the speed option. That was a speed option that time, and he decided to tuck it and go with it all the way. Good job, Ben Street. He looked like a good, mature quarterback that time. He made a good decision to tuck it and run and not worry about his pitch man. And it paid off for him with 6 points.
Quan McKinney with the Southern Union kickoff. Begin at Southern Union. You can go absolutely anywhere. Back deep. For Sylacauga, is that Thomason back to return it? Looks like it may be. Short kick. Going to be fielded to the 25-yard line. Slip momentarily. Now to the 30. Cuts back with a good gain across the 35 to the 37.
All right, now here's the time where our defense has to stand up and stop this quarterback running the football. That's been what we haven't been able to stop tonight. They're running the option. They're running their zone read. We've stopped the running back for the most part. We've definitely stopped the dive on the option. We haven't stopped the quarterback running the football. We've got to do that in order to win this football game. If not, he's going to nickel and dime us down the field. They may run a play action here. After they run that option, beat us deep. We just got to do a good job of stopping the quarterback running the football.
First down and 10. It's going to be Thomason around right side, a huge gain. He's got five. He's got 10 running through defenders inside the 45 to the 43. My goodness,
yeah,
what a run.
And that was a good read by the quarterback there. They had it all the way. We got blocked at the outside linebacker and middle linebacker position. And then even they got their left backside tackle on our safety, and he made a good block. So, you know, a good play there to answer from Sylacauga. And, I mean, they're in good field position right now.
Moves it inside the Vols' 43-yard line. First down and 10 for the Aggies. Two split outs come to the near side. One will go to the far side. Walker, this time he'll keep it left side. In trouble, going to be hit and driven back. Marcus Heflin followed him down the line of scrimmage. When he stopped, Heflin was there. And Munchie will bring him down. No gain on the play.
Good play, Marcus Heflin, but give credit to JT Ledd as well that time. The outside linebacker here stayed at home. He knew it was an option. He read the quarterback the whole way. Didn't allow himself to get suckered inside on the dive and strung it out long enough for Marcus to make the play from the backside. So good technique was the reason that we stopped him that time.
Second down. This time Thomason gets a call right side. He'll find his way through a defender, but to the 41 only, going to set up a big third down play.
Well, they pulled the left guard that time, and we've done a really good job at the outside linebacker position of taking on the guards and holding our own against the guards. Now, we've been kicked out by the tackles a couple of times, and we've been out of position a couple of times, but we do a good job of keeping things sealed off to the inside when they pull a guard. That time, Marcus Heflin, again, he seals down, and we make a good play there and stop him. Pretty good defensive play there.
Third down and 9. Going to be Walker, keeps it right side, breaks the first tackle, but the friends arrive and will bring him down.
Yeah, good gang tackle. Got Clay Tuck shot the gap that time, and if you shoot the gap, Tommy, you got to make the tackle. Now, we were fortunate that time that our friends were flowing down the line and made a good tackle. So, good job, Tyler Smith, of walking that chain and or walking that fence and making a play. But Clay Tuck, good job of shooting that gap and getting back there to him, but you got to be a sure tackler, at least hold on till your buddies arrive. Good defensive stop for the Volunteers. We should get the ball back in decent field position.
Good punt out of there. Angles, that's too deep. It looks like it's about 8 yards deep in the end zone, so not a lot of touch on that one.
No. You know, when you're a young punter, that's something that you'll develop as you go on. And I got to think, you know, he's got the leg to do some punting maybe at a small school at the next level, but that's a booming punt. I mean, I'm just very impressed with not just his distance, but his height on the punt.
Strong kicking game.
Yeah.
And the pregame warm-ups, field goal kicker was from 50, was right on line,
yeah,
and didn't look too bad from there. Tied at 7. Volunteers trying to get something going offensively again. Handoff right side. McKinney out across the 20 to the 24, a step away from really picking up a huge gain. Instead, he'll gain about 4. Brings up second down. We'll call it 6.
The reason that play works, Tommy, is because they run a 4-3 defense where they have 3 linebackers. We're running a double slot, which means they have to split the linebackers off on our flankers. When they do that, all that is you got to get your receiver, get positioned to block that outside linebacker, seal down on the tackle with your tackle, let the guard reach that middle linebacker on the next level, and that's why we're picking up good yardage on that run there.
Shotgun look, Street. Second down and about 6. He'll take it, fake it, quarterback sweep left side, looking for a block, finds one, and he'll pick up first down yardage across the 30 to the 31.
Hey, Blair Lacey's going to feel that block tomorrow. He threw a good block. I think he may have got the rougher end of the deal, but he laid his body out there, and that's what sprung us for a first down there. So when you go back and watch that replay of that play, you got to say Blair Lacey, good block there, and that's what picked up that first down. Now, like I said, he's going to feel that one tomorrow morning, but he laid it out there and made a good block.
Good for the Generals Cafe. First down. Volunteers out across the 30-yard line. Tied up at 7. Quarterback keeper again. Street cuts it in. Got a little running room. Breaks a tackle. He's across the 45. And another Volunteer first down.
And I'm going to say it again, Tommy. great block from the tight end position from Blair Lacy, and that's how you reach block somebody. If you're he's not bigger than anybody out there. Yeah. He's tall, he's skinny, but he plays good. He gets in good position when he blocks. Get that head on the right side, get your body turned, and just seal him off, and let your speedy backs, and that time your quarterback, use their speed to get out on the outside. Good block from Blair Lacy, and a good lead block from the back as well.
Another first and 10, straight to Heflin. Heflin to midfield and falls forward to about the 48-yard line.
Hey, for once, I can say this. We're doing a good job of running the football. You know, we're doing a really good job running the football out of the spread. We pulled Adam Brown that time. He led up in the hole, made a good block, and our backs are hitting those holes hard. They're finding good seams right now.
Also, Josh Smith leading the way, sophomore, or check that, junior, with a good block in the interior. Three wide outs go to the left. DJ Ford to the near side. Second and about four. Street, left side, bounces outside. He's diving for the first down. It's going to depend on the spot.
I think we've ran Ben more tonight than we have all year long, and he's doing a good job of answering the call and picking up those first downs for us. That's a good play there, that little zone read. I think it's designed to keep the ball, though, because we're pulling that backside guard and tackle and leading up in that hole, and he's just following right behind him, and that's, you know, following two bulldozers and picking up the first down.
Good for another General's Cafe first down. Volunteers at the 44-yard line. Split outs either way. Street takes it, hands it off up the middle. A little bit of a running room there for Jennings. He'll fall forward to the 41.
Well, nose guard sort of clogged that one up for him, or I should say the tackle sort of clogged that one up for him. They're running that 4-3. I felt like we had him out of position that time here on the right side. And we did a good job of sealing down on the right, but he sort of clogged it up. And that's their best defensive play. And if their best defensive play of the drive has been a 2.5-3 yard pickup, then we're doing fairly good offensively.
A couple of wide outs either way. Street steps up, confusion in the backfield, broken play. He'll get to the 40, and that's going to be about it. I'm not sure what happened there. It looked like Jennings and Street stood there and looked at each other for a period of time, and Street able to scamper forward, sets up third and about 5.5 to 6.
Well, I thought he was trying to fake it and then throw, but there was nobody out here to catch the ball. So I don't know if he just read the play wrong or forgot what it was, or maybe it was supposed to be a handoff, but confusion. And we were fortunate that time to pick up what we did. And, you know, we talk about mental mistake-free football. Well, if you have a good quarterback that's athletic like Ben, if you do make a mental mistake, sometimes you can cope for it with your athleticism, and that time that's what he does and picks up a couple of yards there on a busted play.
Big third down play here. It's the option to the right side, pitching it back. Nothing there. Wow. Jennings is pummeled right at the line of scrimmage, going to set up fourth down.
Well, the safety comes up and makes a good play, Tommy. We run the option, and safety comes up, makes a good play, and you know, that's just going to happen sometimes in football. He made a good tackle.
Vols look to be punting the football away. Dawson Harry will punt it. Try to pin. Sylacauga deep. Do you fake it here?
Hey, it might be time. We haven't done it yet this year.
Nope. Harry kicks it away.
Good punt.
High floating kick. Going to be fielded at the 15. That's where it'll be. First down and 10 for Sylacauga when we come back. 2:59 left here in the third. We're tied at 7. Vols football continues in a moment.
First State Bank is a community-owned bank established in 1971 with a mission to be the bank for all people in the area with a primary focus on good old-fashioned customer service. First State Bank has convenient branches located in Lineville, Ashland, and Wedowee. Since its founding, First State Bank has continued to grow and keep up with the banking industry changes in technology to give its customers the best service available, such as internet and mobile banking. First State Bank, here to make dreams come true for people just like you.
Cabinets Feed and Farm Supply on the corner of Highway 280 and Quarry Road in Sylacauga is Central Alabama's complete feed and farm supply headquarters with full feed lines for horses, cattle, and pets from Purina, Nutrina, and Pennington. And if you're gearing up for hunting season, make sure to get all your clover and deer mixes. Need more space or own your own hunting club? Find full lines of Cotton State buildings at Cabinets and free delivery for 50 miles and relaxed financing. Get all your land, farm, and feed needs from Cabinets Feed and Farm on Highway 280 in Sylacauga.
Are you sure we should take this billboard down?
People find out State Farm does car loans as well as they do insurance. Our bank is through.
Good point. Grab an edge.
Look, there's two guys on the State Farm Borrow Better banking sign.
No, for real, there's two dudes on the State Farm
Borrow Better banking sign.
Gentlemen, please get down from the State Farm Borrow Better banking sign. Phil, get the hose.
Okay, he's getting the hose.
All right, let's go.
Want to borrow better? Contact State Farm agent Mike Coleman about a car loan that can save you hundreds.
We are a debt relief agency. We help people file Chapter 7 and Chapter 13 under the bankruptcy code.
Marcia Mason is pleased to announce the new location of Mason Law Firm at 217 Madison Street in Alexander City. Marcia Mason is your local attorney for bankruptcy and Social Security disability. Call your hometown attorney, Marcia Mason, at 256-329-1313. All initial consultations are free and strictly confidential.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be provided is greater than that of other attorneys.
Want a personal car buying experience? Come by Kia of Auburn and see us. We will find you the exact vehicle that you're looking for. Want leather seats or sunroof? You got it. Red, black, or white. The choice is all up to you. We will find you the car of your dreams. You can own a 2015 Kia Sportage LX for $25,183, which includes Kia's 10-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty. Stop by today at 1687 South College Street or shop online at kiaofauburn.com. War Eagle.
General's Cafe in Newsite is the area's number one place for great food with great people. General's Cafe has only the best home-cooked food served hot and fresh and is sure to feed your appetite. General's has everything from the delicious fish plate to big juicy steaks. Come in every day for lunch and get the daily special, which will fill your belly and save you money. When you're looking for a good meal in a family-friendly atmosphere, then make the short drive out to General's Cafe on Highway 22 East in Newsite.
Silicaga's got it first down and 10, starting at their own 15-yard line. Walker steps back, going to look for his man deep. He's got him down there, and
good play.
Davin Flanord, step for step on the outside, able to bat that one away, going to bring up second and 10.
That's great coverage from Davin. I thought he got suckered inside on the play action, but able to recover in good position, and that's where you have to make an excellent Aaron Rodgers-type throw in order to complete that. But you know, a good job getting his hands up, finding the football, turning his head back, finding the football, and deflecting it. Good play by Davin.
Second down and 10. Sulacaga. As Walker runs the option left side, pitches back. Oh, showtime! Big stick in there. That is going to be Lacey. Comes up with a big league hit on Thomason.
Hey, Blair Lacey's having the game of his career tonight. He's done good offensively. He's made some good plays defensively right there. You read that one the whole way. You know the option's coming. You come up, nobody blocking you. And you know you have the pitch, man. The quarterback pitches it early, and you just lay him out. That's what you got to have there. Sending a message, making a statement saying, hey, you run the option to my side, you're going to pay for it.
Blair Lacey, as you said, has had a great game here tonight. Shotgun formation. Third down now, 13 yards to go. Walker takes it, rolls left. Tucks it, breaks it back, got a little running room. He'll bring it out, but Tuck will track him down at about the 17.
Good job, Clay Tuck. I mean, you know, when you got a running quarterback, that's something that you got to be aware of when he's throwing, is that he'll tuck it and run it. Found a little bit of a seam that time. Clay was able to readjust himself and come back and make a good open field tackle and saved us from picking up a first down, I think, because if he had missed that one, he'd have been running.
DJ Ford is back to return the punt.
I like that. I like letting DJ return, you know, getting the ball in his hands, letting him make a play.
And I think ball stand to get good field position.
Yeah, I think we left our starter in defense out instead of putting a return on probably.
Wow, big kick. Ford's going to catch it. He'll break a tackle, spin, and Ford to about the 46-yard line. First down and 10 there.
Hey, that's good coverage by the Silicaga Aggies. I mean, you know, they had four guys down there to make the tackle and just hemmed up old DJ. But I really like, and he's done it maybe two or three other times this year, but I really like DJ back deep for us to return it. I like getting the ball in his hands and trying to let him make a play out of it. And, he's our most explosive player. And, getting the ball in his hands as much as possible is a good thing.
Ford, one-on-one over here on the near side. Three receivers go to the left, first and 10. Street will take it, step straight back. Looking, going to go to DJ. Got a step. DJ adjusts and has it knocked away at the last moment.
Number five,
Hey, you know, good coverage from six there. You got to give it to him. DJ had a step on him. You just got to, you know, that's a really hard throw to make as a quarterback to lay it out just a little bit more. DJ was able to elevate over him. He just got to come down with it. Six got his hand up in there. Good coverage, though. And that's not a bad play.
The story there for Sylacauga, battled until they hit the ground. I mean, yeah. You know, he really raked the ball out of his hands.
Yeah.
Sets up second down and 10.
They do a good job of coaching their corners. I mean, you know, one of them's a backup in there right now, and they've made some pretty decent plays against some really good receivers tonight.
This time, handoff right side, McKinney. Inside the 45 to the 43. Gain of about three. Brings up third down, about seven.
And, you know, I say that incomplete pass is a good play. That's because it keeps them honest. It reminds them that we have a big play receiver that will try to burn you deep, and we're not scared to throw it to him. So, you know, you got your corners playing a little on their heels. You got your safety playing a little on his heels. And it keeps them honest back there in the secondary. So, good play.
Third and about seven. Heflin in the backfield alongside Street. Street leaves it with Heflin left side. Heflin cuts it up at the 40. Going to be buried in a sea of white there.
Yeah.
And it's going to bring up fourth down about three.
Well, you know, we let the backside tackle make that play. We didn't seal him off. That's why it's so important to block, even if the play's running away from you. You got to get your head across and seal him off from getting over there and flowing down the line and making a tackle. That time we got a good initial first step on him, but we didn't get our head across and seal him off. He flows down the line and makes a tackle before we could pick up a first down.
Sets up fourth down and about three and a half, and that's going to be the end of the third, so a little time to think about it. Do you roll the dice here at the 39-yard line? We're going to take this time out. When we come back, it's fourth quarter action. We are tied at seven. The Vols in Sylacauga in a Class 5A Region 3 showdown here at Volunteer Stadium. Back with more football right here in just a moment.
Purchasing a new home is easier than you think, and America's Home Place can show you the way. For over 41 years, we've built thousands of homes for people just like you. We guide you through the entire process from purchasing a lot, finding financial options, to putting the finishing touches on your beautiful new house. Come tour our showroom and see over 100 customizable floor plans. Visit us online at americashomeplace.com/TV for a free floor plan book. America's Home Place. We make building easy.
Young's Drug Store has proudly served the citizens of Lineville and the surrounding areas for more than 50 years, providing fast, friendly service. At Young's Drug Store, you're more than just a number, which is why we strive to always greet you with a warm hello and friendly smile. Young's Drug Store offers a convenient drive-through window, prescription compounding, vaccination services, and after-hours emergency availability to better serve you. Young's Drug Store now even has the convenience of viewing and refilling your prescriptions online at youngsdrugstorellc.com. Young's Drug Store, located on Highway 9 in Lineville, 256-396-5632.
Service, selection, quality, and value is hard to find all in one package, but the all-new JD's Tire and Lube Center at the Old Voshees location in Alex City delivers. Get full service at the pump with JD's no ethanol fuel and diesel fuel. JD's Tire and Lube offers any brand of tire you can name. With professional installation and fast turnaround, JD's does all your vehicle maintenance work, and you can always expect great service on all we do at a price that delivers value. JD's Tire and Lube in Alex City is the total package for all your vehicle needs.
There's people who care where I'm going, and good friends who welcome me home. So get a full tank of freedom, drive the American road. And with a full tank of freedom, find your own highway. We'll take you wherever you go. Take you wherever you go.
Visit any of these area Marathon Station locations.
Want a personal car buying experience? Come by Kia of Auburn and see us. We will find you the exact vehicle that you're looking for. Want leather seats or sunroof? You got it. Red, black, or white. The choice is all up to you. We will find you the car of your dreams. You can own a 2015 Kia Sportage LX for $25,183, which includes Kia's 10-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty. Stop by today at 1687 South College Street or shop online at kiaofauburn.com. War Eagle.
Scooter's Grill in Hagnable is serving up some good old-fashioned cooking. Scooter's Grill has a hot buffet with meats and all your favorite home-cooked sides every Tuesday through Thursday from 11 to 1 and 5 to 7. Steak specials are every Friday and Saturday with a ribeye, salad bar, baked potatoes for only $16.99. Of course, all your southern flavors like your pork chops, hamburger steaks, catfish, and much more, including the famous Scooter's Burger with Scooter's secret sauce. So load up the family, get to Scooter's Grill for the best food at affordable prices in Hagnable. Good food, good friends, good times.
Remember when riding a motorcycle meant thinking different? It still does. Star Motorcycles. We build it. You make it your own. Make a star your own now.
Visit Yamaha of Sylacauga on Highway 280, 256-245-2255, or online, yamahaofsylacauga.com.
Volunteers facing fourth down and a short four. Dawson Harry to punt the football away. Story to return the kick, standing at the 10. It's fake. A fake. Off to Lacey. Lacey cuts it up, got his first down and more. Blair Lacey, 25-20 to the 18. We said a possible fake, and the Vols run it to perfection. Lacey gets the first down.
Hey, and you can't help but smile for the guy. He's a hard-nosed, good technique player. He plays hard every single play. Comes up with the biggest play of the night thus far on the fake punt. He's excited. I'm excited for him, man. That's just a great play by a great player right there.
Snapped it to him as he up back, and Blair Lacey going to pick up the first down on the fake punt. Great play, and again, hats off to Lacey. He is, as we said, the game of his life here tonight at Volunteer Stadium.
Man, what a big play there from Blair Lacey. And he's blocked well all night. He's done the unspoken behind-the-scenes things all year where he's played good technique defensively. He's made good blocks. And it's paying off for him in the biggest game of the season so far, and he's having a great game.
Street, quarterback keeper right side, finds a gap, spun down. He'll get inside the 15 to about the 13-and-a-half-yard line.
And Blair Lacey's becoming my favorite player because of things he does, just like he just did on that play. A good, hard kick-out block there at the tight end, opens up a hole, and we pick up 5 yards. That's the unspoken behind-the-scenes things that he does that makes a good player. You know, it's you got to have superstars, and you got to have good players that play good plays on every play, and that's Blair Lacey. He's a good player that plays hard on every play.
Street drops it, picks it back up, in trouble in the backfield, breaks two tackles, a third, but then brought down. He will fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but it's going to bring up third down.
Well, that's one of those mental mistakes. You know, you got to watch the ball in all the way before you do something with it. He just tried to move before he got the football. And it's like we said earlier, you know, with the athletic quarterback, sometimes you can cope for a mistake. And he coped enough that time to get back to the line of scrimmage. So, big play coming up here. You know, we've had opportunity after opportunity here in the red zone, and we haven't capitalized except for the one speed option where we did. But, you know, maybe that's what we do here is we look back to the speed option here to the left side, or I'm thinking maybe try one of those receivers again on a quick comeback or a hitch.
Street steps back, sets up the screen out here to McKinney, and unable to connect with him.
Yeah, the linebacker got his hands up, and he just couldn't find the football.
Harry's going to have the field goal opportunity right here. He's 0 for 2 in field goals this season.
Well, you know, this is a good call, I think, Tommy.
Oh, yeah, no doubt.
I mean, it puts you up. Your defense has been playing well all night, and they're playing even better here in the second half. You know, Dawson has the ability to hit this. Now, does he have the confidence right here? Does he get good blocking, a good snap, and a good hold? We'll see right here.
Miss from 39 and 20. This is a 30-yard effort. The kick by Harry is up, and the kick is good.
Hey, he answered the call, Tommy. Big play there from Dawson Harry. He answers when he has to. This is the most important field goal of the year, that's for sure. It puts you up on a good Sylacauga team. Now, it's on the defense. Can you hold? They've been running the option. The quarterback's been running. You got to think that eventually they're going to come out and try to throw it a little bit more. But can you hold defensively? It's time to man up, play Volunteer defense.
30-yard field goal for Dawson Harry. Volunteers go on top 10-7 here with 10-17 remaining in the ballgame.
And you set the tone right here on the kickoff, Tommy. You get a good kick from McKinney, a good deep kick, and you run down the field full speed and hit somebody hard. And that sets a tone for your defense, gets them fired up and gets the momentum in your favor. And you play some good defense. So let's set the tone right here on this kickoff.
Sounds like time for popcorn.
Hey.
Zach Horn has been known to deliver a punch or two. Story back to return the kick. He's standing at the 15-yard line. This time Harry to kick off. As he will have your Southern Union kickoff here with 10-17 remaining. Dawson Harry's kick.
Good kick.
Nice booming kick. Story back to the 10. Story to the 15 to the 20. Tries to bounce it outside. Spins away from the first defender and going to be brought down at about the 24-yard line.
I thought we was going to have him there, but, you know, we had our friends coming back and made a good tackle. So, you know, we can live with this defensively. Here we go. Got to step up right here and answer the call. We put the big freshman in, and looks like we want to play a four lineman front right here, maybe go to the 4-3.
Kendrick Terman led the charges down the field that time. Vols lead 10-7. We've got 10:09 left here in the ballgame.
It looks like we're going to stay with the 3-4. Just got the big meat up front at nose guard.
Back to the I formation. Option right side, a big gap up the middle. Out across the 35. DJ Ford gets a hand on Thomason to bring him down.
Well,
not until he gains 12 yards. It's first and 10.
That's our linebacker there, Clay Tuck. He just didn't. He filled the hole with his head down. You got to get your head up and find the back, buddy, and make a tackle.
First down and 10.
That's just that first step of the option. It's the dive, and our linebacker's got to make that play.
They will switch back to the I formation. Thomason, the fullback. Ross, the tailback. First and 10, bobble on the snap, hands it off. Thomason carrying defenders forward. He's inside or outside the 40 to the 42. Another gain of 5.
Well, they're eating us up right now with the dive, and that just goes to show you, you know, it's the option for you. When the quarterback's been working all night or the pitch has been working all night, then you sort of start trying to overcompensate for that. You forget your initial responsibility, which is the pitch, the dive back, and that right now is eating us up. Good play there.
Good play in the backfield. That's a tuck on the stop. Clay Tuck back to make the hit.
Yes, sir. Good
Brings
play.
A big third down here.
He saw the open hole, and he filled it very well and upended the back. And that's a good play from a good middle linebacker there.
Third down, about 6.5 now for Sylacauga. Big play here with 9 minutes remaining. Split backfield. Hands it off up the middle.
Good play.
So third and 7. Sylacauga goes to the dive.
And you see who made the tackle on those last two runs was Clay Tuck. He missed that first one down here when he didn't have his head up and didn't see the back. He answers when he has to, though, and makes some good tackles there on the lead plays. And that's why we're in punt return formation now.
DJ back to return the punt again. Fourth down and about 5. Good snap. Another good punt out of there. High floating.
Watch out.
Going to hit and let it roll. To the 30 to the 29. Volunteers will have it first down and 10 at the 29-yard line. 8:09 left here in the ball game. Central leading 10-7. Here at Volunteer Stadium.
All right, we need to get the ball here and run off some time, Tommy. We don't necessarily have to score. Let's march it down the field, run off some time, and if we could score, obviously that'd be a good thing because they're having trouble moving the ball on us right now. So if we could even just get a field goal, you know, put us up where they have to score, you know, that's big for our defense right now is that we move the ball, eat up some time, and try to get at least a field goal.
A couple of split outs either way for Street. First down and 10. Street keeps it left side, hitting the backfield, going down there.
Well, two things on that play, Tommy. Backside, that was the backside in the 4-3. He comes through untouched, and we got to seal him off. That's number one. Number two, you got to sell that fake a little better if you're the running back. You know, I know it's the zone read, and you're thinking, well, I didn't get the ball, so I'm out of the play. No, you're not. Run like you have it because that guy there may see you running hard and deviate just enough for Ben to hit up in that hole. So sell that fake if you're the running back.
Second down, about 10.
Here's that diamond
formation. Here's the diamond look to the near side. DJ Ford to the far side. They'll quick hitch it out here to Flanord with a lot of running room. Flanord gets a block.
Good block.
40.
41.
Flanord with another block. A flag back here.
Oh.
As Flanord goes to the 10, to the 5, down to the 1, and a flag back at the 35-yard
line. They're going to call a hold out here, and that is a absolutely, and I'm going to say that's a terrible, terrible call. And you can see right now the offense coordinator, Coach Burns, down there is livid, and I don't blame him. I am too. They're going to call a hold on a great block out here from 21, Zachary. I mean, there's no other way to put it, but that is a terrible call.
That's you can rewind and DVR that one back, and there is no way that is a penalty over in the near side. That is a tough, tough call against the Volunteers.
And you can see Chris Heron right now is pretty upset himself, and he's talking to the official that made the call, and I wish I could just be a fly on his shoulder right now to hear what he's saying, because I'm going to say it's probably not pretty pleasant. That's a huge play right there and a great – and I'm going to tell you, if you're watching this game and you're thinking, you know, you're younger and you're maybe in junior high or something, that's how you block as a receiver. You get between them and the ball. There wasn't anything about that was a hole.
Great play. Goes for naught. Instead, it is a second down and about 14.
But you got to shake that off and play football right here. Answer with a good play.
Street keeps it left side. Block. He'll bring it across the 30 to about the 35-yard line.
And even though it's called back, the momentum's still on your side because you know that it worked. You know that it picked up a good play. You got the momentum right now. They're reeling. They're on their heels. Good run there from Ben. That's a great pickup. And we're in a very manageable third and five right here.
Sets it up. Third down. We'll call it about four to go. Needing to reach the 39-yard line for the first down. Clock now with 6:45 left. Three wideouts go to the right. One comes to the left. Big play here for the Vol offense. Street gives it off near side, running room for McKinney. McKinney 45. McKinney with a move. 45 to the 35-yard line. Quan McKinney on a great run and picks up a huge first down.
Great run, Quan McKinney, and it was a little counterplay, and it was set up perfectly by the pull-in right guard. Neil Anderson had an amazing block that time, and he's really stepped up and become a great offensive lineman for this Volunteer defense. But Quan McKinney read that block very well, picked up good yards. He keeps those legs running high, and that's a huge play for the Volunteer offense.
10-7, your First Aid Bank score. Volunteers on the move, 6:17 remaining in the ball game. Touchdown here makes it a two-score game. Street goes to Heflin right side. Heflin with a cut, 30, 25. Heflin down to the 24-yard line. That is a gain of about 9. It's going to set up a second and 1.
And the difference in the first half and the second half of running the football is that our running backs are hitting the holes that our offensive line have created. They've been there all night. We've done a good job up front, I feel like, all night. But the difference in the first half and the second half is that we are picking up, or we're seeing those holes that they're creating, and we're hitting them.
That's exactly what I was thinking. The holes have been there. Now you're seeing the backs become more confident every play, and they're able to make a move in the hole and get positive yardage. It is second and a yard. Heflin stands to the left of Street. He'll get the call. Finds a hole, finds a first down. He's down to the 20-yard line with another General's Cafe first down.
You know, Tommy, I really feel like that this has been the best game as a whole up front that we've had all year from our offensive line. Now, I don't know what the stats were from the first half. They may not indicate that, but you can watch this game film, and you can see that we've really done a good job of blocking, especially our offensive line on their defensive line. Now, we've had some problems getting to the second level, but we've sort of remedied that here in the second half. And our backs are finally hitting those holes that we're creating. And you see that it's working out positively for the Volunteers.
Three wideouts will go to the right, one to the left. Street alongside Heflin. Street keeps it right side, cuts it back, got a gap. 15, 10. He takes it down to the 8-yard line. And I absolutely love the spread look with this offense. This is the way the zone read and the spread should work.
Yeah, and you see it's working to success right now. And I really feel like here in this drive that we have found an offensive identity where we've run these quick off-corner plays, the answered back with a counter, then a zone read, and it's working to success. And then you see the big pass play that was negated. That's still, you know, part of that whole process of running the offense. And I really feel like that in this drive we have found an offensive identity for the first time this year.
Split outs, three will go to the right, one comes to the left. That is Flanord. Street and McKinney in the backfield. It's Street, right side, following Dawson Taylor. Street will hammer his way down to about the five.
Hey, and that's a good run there. Dawson Taylor with a good lead block and Ben running right behind him, hitting that hole. It takes a guy from the backside coming across and making a tackle. And right now, we are hitting on all cylinders offensively.
Dawson Taylor up a little gimpy as he will try to stay in the ball game. I don't know that he's going to be able to. He's trying to battle through it. You see him there on the screen.
Yeah, I don't know. I think it may have been his arm, or it looked like he was sort of holding his arm a little loose there, but I don't know. Maybe got his bell rung a little bit.
A little bit of a knee. He's had some knee issues, okay. And he's hobbling coming back, but he's staying in there.
Hey, hard fighter. Got to
fight through
it.
Second and goal from just outside the three. Street takes it. Goes to Heflin, touchdown, six. Volunteers.
Hey, and I'm going to say it now. I've been waiting to say it. Best offensive drive that we've had all year. We drive it the length of the field. We get a big penalty that sets us back. We overcome that, drive it the length of the field again, and score a touchdown off of a good running play. And I think maybe there was only one pass that time. That was a great offensive possession that time. And I mean, we looked like a good football team right there, Tommy.
Great run by Heflin from 3 yards out. Harry on for the extra point, trying to make it a 17-7 lead. The hold, the kick is up, and the kick is good. 17-7, your new First Aid Bank score. We'll take this timeout and continue. Vols football continues in a moment right here on WAXC-TV.
You may know them from high school, from the local grocery store, or even your own neighborhood. These local teens have embarked on a new journey, one that begins at Southern Union State Community College. Visit suscc.edu/journey to see the life's journey these students have planned. We believe that you have an amazing journey ahead of you too, and Southern Union is the perfect place to begin at an affordable price close to home. Southern Union, where the journey begins.
At Cabinets Direct, we strive to provide top-quality products along with professional and courteous service. As a family-owned and operated company, we have over 40 years of combined experience in cabinetry sales and installation. We offer a wide range of cabinetry with fully customizable options. We also use only locally made products, keeping our money in our community. For more information, give us a call or visit our showroom. Cabinets Direct.
How do I know if my baby sees well? What should my preschooler be able to see? How quickly can a child's vision change? How old is old enough for contact lenses? What is macular degeneration? Is it inherited? How does diabetes cause blindness? If you've got questions, we've got answers. See Dr. James Poole and Dr. Ernest Champion at Family Eye Care, 329-8400. Check yearly, see clearly.
Your day takes you. A water heater from Blossman means a reliable hot shower when you need it.
Here's the deal. Standard tank propane water heaters for only $99. Free installation.
Over the years, S&S Tire has grown into the Lake Martin area's largest volume tire dealer. S&S Tire offers the industry's best brand names, Michelin, Goodyear, BF Goodrich, Uniroyal, Firestone, and much, much more. The tire pros at S&S offer professional installation and the region's best price. In addition to your tire needs, S&S offers full automotive mechanical work for all your vehicle maintenance and repair needs with the area's most experienced staff. Visit either of our two locations on Cherokee Road in Ellic City or at South Street in Dadeville. At S&S Tire, we're installing peace of mind for every customer we serve. Every job, every day.
The best Mexican dining experience around is found at Monte Alban Mexican Restaurant. Real authentic Mexican cuisine and atmosphere awaits you at Monte Alban, with great specials on popular dishes such as the pollo asado and beef or chicken chimichangas. Choose from select dinner or lunch combinations, and you can buy one and get one half off. Want to celebrate your birthday? Get a free drink, meal, and dessert when you dine in. Two convenient locations on the Court Square in Ashland and on Highway 9 in Lineville to serve you.
Volunteers lead by 10, 17-7, 3:33 remaining. Dawson Harry on for the Southern Union kickoff. Begin at Southern Union. You can go absolutely anywhere. Harry's kick, another good boomer. Taken back, it's a 15-yard line to the 20. Finds a gap, breaks a tackle, spins away, does Story, and he'll be brought down just outside the 30-yard line. Volunteer defense, you got a 10-point lead, 3 minutes, 26 seconds. As we mentioned in the pregame and throughout the night, this is a huge game in the region race. A win here tonight, a win next week for the Volunteers secures the second place spot and a home game in round one.
Yeah, and you got to think that if we can win this one, if we come out here with a victory, we should take care of business in Talladega.
Walker rolls out left, throwing it deep. Got a man down there and unable to hang on. Again, good coverage by Lacey as he is out here in coverage.
Yeah.
It brings up second down and 10.
But, you know, he had a step on us. Blair was able to recover. You got to watch that. Wheel route's hard to cover coming out of the backfield there. And, you know, he was a little late getting over there, but he was able to recover. And, you know, it puts us in a good position with them second and 10. We can sort of start dialing up some pressure here maybe.
Lacey comes out. He's over on the sideline saying, hey, you remember that fake punt? Hand off up the gut. Not a whole lot there. It's going to bring up a third down for Sylacauga.
And the clock is running, Tommy. You know, you gotta expect. And if you're DJ and Davin in the secondary, you got to think that it's coming with the shot down the field because they're going to need to score quickly here with us up 10.
Not in any kind of hurry. We're under 3 minutes remaining now. Second and about seven.
Yeah.
That's actually third down, isn't it?
They're telling them to change it.
Now it's third down and seven. They get everything right. Rolls to the right. He's in trouble, and everybody meets at the quarterback. Casey Jones, Dawson Taylor, Clay Tuck, and Malik Dark are all right there for the big sack.
And it's Malik Dark out of the nose guard position. It's just too quick for their center to handle. And as soon as the ball snapped, I don't know if they had a slant on or if he just chose the side, but he went. He knew the pass was coming, and he got back there and held him up and forced him into the open arms of Dawson and the other lineman there. And good play there from our defensive line. That's what we need. They're going to punt it. Surprised.
Almost getting a hand on it. It's Dark. Nobody back deep. They'll just let it roll. And it will roll dead at the 40-yard line. The Volunteers will start first down and 10 with a minute 54 remaining. Balls are going to get a big win here tonight at Ball Stadium.
You know, I'm not one to question coaching, Tommy. I try not to, but I wonder why they punted. I don't think I'd have tried to go for it. I really do. I know they hadn't really moved it on us the second half here, but I probably would have tried to go for it and see what I could have got. But, you know, I know they got three timeouts here, but I'm expecting three runs and let that clock run. And, you know, even if they do get the ball back, it will be with probably less than a minute left of
It's hard to score twice.
Yeah, it's hard to score twice in less than a minute.
Street in the backfield with Heflin. First down and 10. Going to be Heflin right side. He'll fall forward across the 40. About the 42. The Vols will start to use that clock here, but yeah. Sylacauga is going to take a timeout.
Yeah, that's their plan is to stop us three and out here and get the ball back, and we'll use all three of their timeouts. But like you said, you know, it's hard to score twice with less than 2 minutes left, you know, and that's where they're at right now. They're down to less than 2 minutes, and you got to think that if they do get the ball back, it'll be, you know, deep pass every time, and if they score an onside kick. But, you know, I feel confident in our secondary. I feel confident in our running game right now. I don't think we're going to get the ball back.
I honestly don't think that they're going to be able to hold us for the first down right here, to be honest with you, the way that the Vols offense is running the football right now.
Right. Well,
and again, I love the look of the spread. And you're getting those running lanes. And like you said, we've been looking for that all year.
Yeah.
And really, you know, when we go to the tight formations, everybody seems to be in a bunch and we can't get anything going. This right here is giving you a lot of territory to run the football.
Well, you know, it fits our offensive line. We're not big, but we're good at pulling, and that's what we do well. So when we run those counters out of the spread, it really works well for us running off tackle, like this play right here.
Street, he'll get a yard, maybe two. Then the push ball pile, going to move it forward. They're trying to rip it out of there. And he will fight his way out to the 47-yard line. My goodness.
You know, I don't know what Ben Street does on his max on squat, but it's got to be up there. He's got super strong legs. I mean, just look at them. They're huge thighs. And that's what moved that pilot. That and the assistance he got from the offensive line, you know, they were right up there with him saying, hey, we're going to help you a little bit here, Ben. Push this pile forward. And Silicaga uses their second timeout.
He's just squatted about nine Aggies, I'll tell
you that.
Yeah,
he did.
And like you said, you'd like to see your offensive line coming up and giving that push there at the end to kind of help it out. And again, moves it forward, brings up third down and about three. Silicaga using that timeout there. That is their second. It's going to leave them only one the rest of the way. But big third down play here for the Vols. Try to get this touchdown, and then it's victory formation time. Don't forget, following the game, Tallapoosa Ford post-game wrap-up. Again, we'll wrap things up and name our Young's Drugstore Player of the Game.
I got one already in mind, Tommy.
I got one as well. And it may be about to maybe pointing in the same direction.
I hope it is.
I'm too cold to fight with you, so probably whatever you say.
Well, there you go. I'm cold too, so.
It is a chilly night, buddy. Two split outs either way. Big third down and three here. Vols try to ice it. Hands it off left side, bouncing off, falls forward, breaks a tackle, 40-yard line, and that's your ball game. Marcus Heflin will pick up the big first down inside the 40 to the 38. And you can paint this win red, white, and blue for the Volunteers.
That's right, Tommy. I mean, you know, they were banking on we were going to go three and out, and two big plays in a row, one from the quarterback, Ben Street, and then one from a running back there, Heflin, picking up the first down. The clock continues to run. We'll just ice it here. I'd say sit in the huddle to about 5 seconds left, and then just get up there and just run a lead or something. Just got to make sure you hold on to the football.
They'll try to get the right personnel in the huddle. Step up. Ben goes up under center. He'll take the snap.
Victory formation.
And take a knee. And the Volunteers going to get a huge win tonight, going 5-3 on the year. Talladega game, don't forget, is Thursday night next week. So if you're planning to go check out the Vols, we hope you will. Come on over to Talladega. That will be Thursday evening, 7 o'clock start at Tiger Stadium. Very big win tonight for this Volunteer team. They needed this one. Down 7-0 at halftime. And a lot of folks you talked to at the break just didn't feel like the Vols were playing very inspired football. Not sure what the message was at halftime, but this has been a different Volunteer team in the second half.
Well, you know, and I'm going to just go ahead and say it, not just the players, but the coaching staff. The play calling was on point here in the second half. And, you know, blocking was good. Our time as far as quarterback to receivers were good. And our running backs were the biggest improvement from half to half, where they were able to find holes in the second half that they maybe were missing in the first. And they just did a good job here of putting it all together on one big drive that capped it off for us with a big touchdown. That's just a good game here in the second half for the Volunteers.
That's your final score. Volunteers win 17-7 over Silicaga. We'll take this timeout. Come back. Vols football continues in a moment right here on WAXC TV.
For over 30 years, Tallapoosa Ford has been your family-owned auto dealer for hot trucks and SUVs. Now they're raising the bar even higher. The Ford F-150 has been the best-selling truck in America for the last 38 years. And the hot new 15s are hitting the scene. And Tallapoosa Ford and Ford trucks are number one for a reason. America's best truck, combined with our award-winning service department for the region's best warranty work and great maintenance and service.
Hello, this is Jeff with Tallapoosa Ford. Ford trucks have led America's truck sales. Come by today and get your best deal on America's best truck. We don't want all the business, just the opportunity to earn yours.
In a world that's ever-changing, you have to be sure that your choices are the right choices. At Central Alabama Community College, you'll know you made the best choice. We understand that you need the best educational opportunities,
Whether choosing a technical degree program, taking courses to transfer to a four-year college or university, or being a part of our national championship-winning traditions, Central Alabama will provide you with courses and degree programs in tune with today's workplace. Get a sharper focus on your life by choosing one of our three convenient locations, Alex City, Childersburg, and Talladega. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
Cabinets Feed and Farm Supply on the corner of Highway 280 and Quarry Road in Sylacauga is Central Alabama's complete feed and farm supply headquarters with full feed lines for horses, cattle, and pets from Purina, Nutrina, and Pennington. And if you're gearing up for hunting season, make sure to get all your clover and deer mixes. Need more space or own your own hunting club? Find full lines of Cotton State buildings at Cabinets and free delivery for 50 miles and relaxed financing. Get all your land, farm, and feed needs from Cabinets Feed and Farm on Highway 280 in Sylacauga.
General's Cafe in Newsite is the area's number one place for great food with great people. General's Cafe has only the best home-cooked food served hot and fresh and is sure to feed your appetite. General's has everything from the delicious fish plate to big juicy steaks. Come in every day for lunch and get the daily special, which will fill your belly and save you money. When you're looking for a good meal in a family-friendly atmosphere, then make the short drive out to General's Cafe on Highway 22 East in Newsite.
Remember when riding a motorcycle meant thinking different? It still does. Star Motorcycles. We build it. You make it your own. Make a star your own now.
Visit Yamaha of Sylacauga on Highway 280, 256-245-2255, or online, yamahaofsylacauga.com.
The best Mexican dining experience around is found at Monte Alban Mexican Restaurant. Real authentic Mexican cuisine and atmosphere awaits you at Monte Alban, with great specials on popular dishes such as the pollo asado and beef or chicken chimichangas. Choose from select dinner or lunch combinations, and you can buy one and get one half off. Want to celebrate your birthday? Get a free drink, meal, and dessert when you dine in. Two convenient locations on the Court Square in Ashland and on Highway 9 in Lineville to serve you.
Back on the Tallapoosa Ford postgame wrap-up. Final score 17-7. It's the Volunteers getting a win tonight over Sylacauga. Taking a look at your scoring in the ballgame. Sylacauga scored with a minute two remaining in the first period. Thomason on a one-yard touchdown run made it a 7-0 lead after the PAT. And that's the way it stood until the second half. The third period, the Vols tied it up with 9:29 left in the third. A 15-yard touchdown run for Ben Street. The extra point by Harry made it a 7-7 game. Then in the fourth period, a big 30-yard field goal for Dawson Harry made it a 10-7 lead. And the Vols closed things out with a 3-yard touchdown run for Marcus Heflin with 3:33 left in the ballgame. 17-7, Volunteers get the win. And David, a big win tonight. That really puts you in the driver's seat as far as hosting that game in the first round of the playoffs.
Yeah, it does, Tommy. All we got to do now is go down to Talladega next week and on a Thursday and take care of business. Now, it'll be a short week of practice. I think that should work well in our favor. I mean, you know, we look good here in the second half. We just got to continue that on over on to Thursday. Now, you know, I'm going to say this. That this game has got to build confidence, yeah. Especially that last drive where we scored a touchdown. That builds confidence here for the Volunteers, and it puts us in the driver's seat, like you said, to host a playoff game in the first round.
Big win tonight, 17-7, the final score. Volunteers get the win. Again, this is the Tallapoosa Ford postgame wrap-up, and again, we appreciate them being a sponsor of Volunteer Athletics. Of course, they don't want all the Ford business. They just want an opportunity to earn yours. Go by and see them at Tallapoosa Ford. We will take this time out. When we come back, it's time to name our Young's Drugstore Player of the Game as we continue. Vols football continues in a moment right here on WAXC-TV.
Service, selection, quality, and value is hard to find all in one package. But the all-new J.D.'s Tire and Lube Center at the Old Voshees location in Alex City delivers. Get full service at the pump with J.D.'s no ethanol fuel and diesel fuel. J.D.'s Tire and Lube offers any brand of tire you can name. With professional installation and fast turnaround, J.D.'s does all your vehicle maintenance work, and you can always expect great service on all we do at a price that delivers value. J.D.'s Tire and Lube in Alex City is the total package for all your vehicle needs.
General's Cafe in Newsite is the area's number one place for great food with great people. General's Cafe has only the best home-cooked food served hot and fresh and is sure to feed your appetite. General's has everything from the delicious fish plate to big juicy steaks. Come in every day for lunch and get the daily special, which will fill your belly and save you money. When you're looking for a good meal in a family-friendly atmosphere, then make the short drive out to General's Cafe on Highway 22 East in Newsite.
Young's Drug Store has proudly served the citizens of Lineville and the surrounding areas for more than 50 years, providing fast, friendly service. At Young's Drug Store, you're more than just a number, which is why we strive to always greet you with a warm hello and friendly smile. Young's Drug Store offers a convenient drive-through window, prescription compounding, vaccination services, and after-hours emergency availability to better serve you. Young's Drug Store now even has the convenience of viewing and refilling your prescriptions online at youngsdrugstorellc.com. Young's Drug Store, located on Highway 9 in Lineville, 256-396-5632.
Red's Catfish Cabin in Crackford, Alabama is adding tailgate specials just for you. Hot wings, bio wings, you can buy one or 200. Get with Larry and the crew at 256-354-7705. Now, they're still going to have that delicious catfish that they're known for, sweet tea, which they're known for, and everything else. If you've never eaten at Red's Catfish Cabin, I want you to go today. That's in Crackford, Alabama.
Are you sure we should take this billboard down?
People find out State Farm does car loans as well as they do insurance. Our bank is through.
Good point. Grab an edge.
Look, there's two guys on the State Farm Borrow Better Banking sign.
No, for real, there's two dudes on the State Farm
Borrow Better Banking sign.
Gentlemen, please get down from the State Farm Borrow Better Banking sign. Phil, get the hose.
Okay, he's getting the hose.
All right, let's go.
Want to borrow better? Contact State Farm agent Mike Coleman about a car loan that can save you hundreds.
And welcome back to Volunteer Stadium. Tommy Wood along with David Burkhalter, a victorious Volunteer Stadium tonight as the Vols win 17-7 over a tough group from Sylacauga here at Vols Stadium. And again, a huge region win tonight for these Vols as they are one win away from securing that second place spot and taking on Talladega next week.
Well, I mean, you know, we said it earlier in the game, that's a game that we should win. All we got to do is Thursday go down to Talladega, take care of business, and we'll be hosting the first round of the playoffs. Now, let me say something about that. That ain't going to be easy.
No.
So we need to take care of business. And whatever draw we get, whether it's second or third, you know, we're going to have a good opponent. It's either going to be Vigor or St. Paul. And we want to play them here on our turf in front of our crowd because we're going to need all the help we can get when we play one of those good opponents.
Again, the Volunteers get the 17-7 win. It's time to name our Young's Drugstore Player of the Game. Young's Drugstore has been serving folks for over 50 years in this area. We appreciate them sponsoring Volunteer football. And, David, you and I have talked about our Player of the Game. And it's a guy that, as we said a few weeks ago, really, we didn't even call his name the first three or four weeks, and we've seen him progress throughout the season. And tonight, hats off to our Young's Drugstore Player of the Game, Blair Lacy.
Yeah, well, I've noticed him all year, and it's like I said earlier, and this sort of sounds bad when most people hear it, but it's really, I mean it as a compliment. He's a great role player. He plays his position very, very well, and you got to have those, you know, on a good team, you got to have those guys that are just rocks. They're going to have great games, game in and game out, no matter what the condition or what the, you know, the element. You're playing a huge region game here for the opportunity to host a playoff game at home. It's a huge game against someone that's sort of a rival, that's right down the road from you. And he steps up to the occasion and plays a great, great game offensively, defensively, and the biggest play of the night, the fake punt on special team. So hats off to Blair Lacy. All year long, he's played hard-nosed. He's played good technique, and it paid off for him tonight with our Player of the Game.
He is definitely our Young's Drugstore Player of the Game. Blair Lacy, congratulations to you, and congratulations to the Vols getting this win tonight. Again, back in action on Thursday, trip to Talladega to take on the Tigers to wrap up the region's